Guys,
Hey guys,
we're
we're
gonna
gonna
be playing with Rob
Rob
Tui
tonight.
tonight.
Some salvage
encounters.
Can hardly
wait
to get
started.
I think he's gonna do some character building for other people first.
So we should be able to do a little chatting about
Jade is one of the new cat people.
Very excited to give this a try.
She's gonna be a ranger.
That's a terrible dice color.
Let's see what we can do better.
Do some green.
More green.
There we go.
All right, that looks pretty good.
I think Yurash is going to come and join us.
That's awesome.
I was a little afraid I'd be alone playing tonight.
You might have been. I'm prepared for anything.
Voila. Okay. I'm opening up FG.
Okay, cool. Have you... Okay, I need to put you on the list. You weren't here. Are you going to make a character, or are you going to use a pre-gen?
Level 1 or level 2?
Level 1.
I've got one that I pulled from your site with the XBL, but I'll bring it in.
Oh, okay.
Scanning for the... Fantasy Games login.
I can give you that. I will direct message that to you in Discord.
Sounds good. I do have another player that said he's interested. Zor, who I played with last night, he may be coming in here shortly.
Yeah, I see that he's in the Twitch chat, so we can welcome him in as well if he wants to be in.
I believe his Christian name is Michael.
Yeah.
We'll be seeing a couple more people pretty soon.
I'm closing your Twitch channel so I don't metagame here.
Yep, that's good.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can you hear us?
Yes, I can.
All right, cool. So which... you already brought it in. Okay.
Yeah, I'm equipping because all these old XPML or whatever they're called.
Well, I have the updated version of that barbarian.
You do? Yeah, I haven't changed anything. So yeah, fire me up.
Okay, then I will bring it in for you. That's the half orc barbarian. Okay, let me bring him in. And then do you have that portrait?
Yes, I do. I can, once you pull that up, I'll add that to it.
Can someone send me the host address?
Yes, I will text you that in 1 second. I send it to you in Discord. Oh, it's the same as and the last thing I sent you in Discord was that.
Okay, so it's the same.
Yeah, it's always the same. And actually, once you sign on to my table, it should always be in your list of previously used logon.
Yeah, it's there. I was just wondering if it's, different every time.
No, usually it's always the same. And even if I change it, I think old ones work. It's a pretty cool system.
All right, awesome.
All right, so let me get back to the character.
What campaign are you running tonight, Rob?
Completely made up.
Excellent. Homebrew.
Homebrew is a very bad and terrible word. We don't use that here in my channel. Homebrew has negative connotations to it. You can call it anything except that. You can call it custom. You can call it made up. You can call it anything you want, but just don't call it homebrew.
IPA.
There you go. Okay, so I put the barbarian in the... Nice, if you open back up the character selection, you should be able to grab him, and he'll be yours.
Got it.
He is pre-approved, so I can check you off. And Zaor, are you wanting to make a character, or are you going to use a pre-generated character?
I'll just use a pre-generated character, man, if that's it, just to save time.
Sure. I can give you a list here once you're on the table. Let me know when you're there, and I'll share a list with you.
I'm here. I'm just waiting for this Fantasy Grounds. Okay, here, Doug, just load it up.
Oh yeah, no. Let me know when you see the table, and then I'll share a list of pre-made characters you can choose from.
I see a table that says character selection.
Okay, close that window. I gotta take a phone call from my neighbor. It might be an emergency, guys. So I'll be right back.
10-4.
All right, I see a list that says available pre-generated characters.
Yeah, that's okay. what Rob was talking about.
My neighbor hung up on me, and maybe it's not an emergency. Okay, you should see a... everybody should see, I guess. Did you get the list of the available pre-generated characters?
Yes, sir.
So you can choose from any one of those and tell me which one you like. Yeah, okay, she's calling back. Hold on, guys. Okay, guys, I'm back. So, yeah, so any one of those on that list you can have, and I'll grab it for you and put it in the game.
All right, let me try that Dragonborn Fighter.
Dragonborn Fighter, okay. Yes, I will go get him. Bring him in. Okay, he's, if you open the characters window again, he's the probably the only guy you can see in there, the blank. It says pre-gen level 1 Dragonborn Fighter. You can grab him.
Rob, full disclosure, I did bump my dex up to 14 from 13 because my other character was at, but I can put it back if you prefer.
You can't change stats unless you change another stat. So, did you, when you say your other character, you mean?
Yeah, my other Urash character, I rolled them, and so these match up.
So the pre-gen has to stay the way it is unless you check with me to change it. You can change it, but if you bring up a stat, you got to bring down another stat, and sometimes when you go up one, you got to go down two, so he had a 13 dex.
Yeah, I moved the dex up to 14 and moved the intelligence from 12 to 11.
Okay, as long as the points are the same for those, that's fine. But you might be a point off now. Because, you know, sometimes it to go to 13 to 14 costs so many points, and from 10 to 11 costs so many, and they're not the same, you know? So let me check that.
Yeah, no worries. I can switch it back if it's more of a problem.
Well, it's not a problem. We can. That's what we're. First hour is for character building, so we're totally within our rights to be looking at stuff like that. So let me grab the point calculator and just make sure that it's okay.
Portrait. Very, very nice.
Yeah, it's 1 point over. So you'd have to make you'd have to lower something. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on a second. 17, 14, 15. Just a second. Let me check. Let me double check.
Okay. Yeah, going from 13 to 14 bumps my AC to 14, and I think my initiative from plus 1 to plus 2.
Right, so it's definitely a thing to do, but you have to take down, instead of taking down your other stat by 1, you'd have to take it down by 2, or take another one down by 1. So, like, your intelligence is 11. If you take that down to 10, it doesn't change anything, but it makes you illegal.
Done.
Okay, cool. All right, so on the player's chart, I can give you an X for checked. It's very exciting for the DM.
And I have to warn everyone, my great axe is named Bergman. I found it in an iceberg, and I believe Odin's forge is where it was created. I haven't discovered its magical properties yet, but I'm looking forward to that.
Oh, good.
Wait, so you have a magical story.
No, it's not magical yet. I'm trying to discover.
Oh, right. I was going to say, no, it's not. yeah, we'll see what happens. Okay, so, Zayor, did you have a name for your character yet, or you haven't decided? Don't forget push to talk if you forget, because we can't hear you if you are talking.
Yeah, it looks like he dropped out of Discord, but he was going in and out a little bit last night, too, so hopefully... There he is.
Oh, there he is. He's got himself silenced, though. There he goes again.
Yeah, I don't know if he's using the web version of Discord or the application, but he probably should be using the application.
Yeah, no one should be using the phone version if they are, because it has many, many bugs.
Yeah, we might want to walk them through downloading the app and loading the PC app.
Yeah, not to sound like a... I have mods for that, but none of them are here. But not to sound like a jerk, but that's part of what I do not want to do while we play the game. I'd rather do that not during game time. So if somebody doesn't know how to get in the game, I'm probably not going to be much help to them, because it's not fair to the other players who are ready to go, you know.
So, Michael, did you download the PC app for Discord so that it would be a little more stable?
I got it, man.
All right, cool.
Okay, cool. He's back. So, did you decide for a name for your... Oh, is it going to be... Well, you're Thorn in the other game, but in this game, are you going to have a different character name?
I just go with the same one.
Gonna go same one? Okay, that's fine. You can do that. Just so I have something to put on the list here.
So, Jade Shu, is that a reference to a princess?
No, it's just a name I like.
Is it a reference to a princess?
I like that. Yeah, it's a good name.
Rob
kind of makes me think of like a Chinese Cinderella kind of thing.
Yeah, I guess I can see that.
We'll wait till about 5:30, and if there are no other people, that want to play at 5:30, then we will start too. No. I don't want you to play two. I only want you to play one. But you can have up to three characters in the world, but you can only play one at a time.
Gotcha.
This is my new experiment that I'm starting. You guys are the first. You guys are the guinea pigs. You guys will be the first. We had character building on the other day, but we did not play. So you guys will actually be the first players in this world. So congrats to you.
Awesome.
Yeah, your advertising campaign has paid off.
Right.
When do you do your Twitch show?
As of now, I broadcast 6 days a week. If you go to the Twitch page and look at the schedule, it's the same times every day. And so with this game, how this is set up for Salvage Worlds, or Salvage Encounters, I'm calling it so far until I come up with a better name. It's every Monday at this time, but on Tuesdays and Saturdays I do it in a slot where I have bi-weekly games, and those games aren't being played. You follow me?
Yep, and I see you're using the Core RPG rule set.
No, 5e.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I don't do anything on my channel except Dungeons & Dragons 5e. Did you get that I was using Core RPG because of the colors of the buttons?
No, in the chat window, it shows that listed on the top there.
It shows it in the chat window.
Yeah, I think it loads it first in Fantasy Grounds, no matter what you play.
Oh, I see. Oh, that's what you're looking at. Yeah, yeah, okay. Yeah, it loads. Yeah, because I think the 5e rule set's built on top of the Core RPG. But if you, but yeah, I don't do anything except Dungeons & Dragons 5e. I don't do Pathfinder. I don't do 3.5. I don't do 4e, which I have retitled Dungeons & Dragons Geometry. I don't do that one.
Yeah, four is what discouraged me from playing for a while.
Yeah, I played when I was a kid in the 80s, and then I didn't play. I played like AD&D, like first edition, and then I didn't play again for 20 years, and I started back with 4E, and I thought, man, this is fun and everything, and I missed Dungeons & Dragons for 20 years. I didn't know how bad off I had it until 5th edition came out, and I'm like, oh, this is so much better.
Yes, I like it a lot better.
So I'm going to troll and see if Mark wants to join us. He's in another channel.
Okay.
Mark's got some other things to do, so he won't be able to join us.
Okay, are you talking about Marcana, his name?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, because I know who that guy is. Okay, can't join us. All right, that's fine. I did, we might have one more coming, Mazrum Kinslayer in Twitch.
Yeah, he was in our game last night. Good dude. He was playing Chuck Northfist.
Yeah, so I gave him permissions for the chat room, so if he finds his way in, we'll be good with him.
Aha, there he is.
How's it going?
What's up? So, Mazrum, did you want to create a character, or did you want to get a pre-generated one for yourself? Because everybody's going to be starting new with first level.
I had a character yesterday. I had somebody port it over. I thought Captain sent you a guy named Chuck Northfist.
No, he didn't send me any, but also I wouldn't... This is a brand new thing, so you would have had to have either made a character or use a pregen.
Yeah, he was brand new.
Okay, but yeah, you talking about Tebow, Captain? Ron?
Yeah, Ron, yep.
Yeah, he didn't, he never sent me anything, or nor did I even talk to him about it, so I don't know. If, I mean, it might be a miscommunication there, whatever.
I'll just do a pregen then.
Okay, let me give you the table alias here.
Yeah, I can tell you Rob's pregens are the bomb.
I just re-uploaded that file. There's 27 of them now because I made an Azamar Bloodhunter. And what I'm gonna do is keep building in that. I'm gonna keep building that entire database of pregens because whenever I play this game, and people are making characters, I will make one alongside of it and just add it to the pregen. So eventually, it'll be huge. It'll have hundreds of different. You know, you can pretty much choose almost any combination. Like a year from now.
That sounds awesome.
That Bloodhunter is the one you were making on Saturday, isn't it?
The one I made on Saturday is the new one, yeah.
That looked really strong.
It was fun. And I'm randomly rolling. I'm like rolling for race. I'm rolling for class. You know, I'm just rolling stuff randomly. And then if I need to not do random stuff, I do it. And I bring in all the equipment and assign their powers and spells or whatever. That's how I'm doing it. So, Maz, let me know when you're on the table and can see the message of the day or whatever, and I will share the list of pregens with you.
We'll let you know.
Uh-oh, did my stream die? What happened?
Yep, stream went off on my phone.
Uh-oh. That can't be good.
That's super weird. Because my... It shows it's still streaming, but it's not.
Have you been doing it off and on since the countdown stopped? Because I've seen it go down 3 times. I just assumed you were switching screens or something.
No. It's probably just having problems, I guess. But I do everything on a laptop. The laptop's only a year old. It's not even a year old. No, I guess it's exactly a year old. I think I got it on December 7th of last year. So it's, you know, it's newer, but I've got Fantasy Grounds, open broadcast system, my bots, Discord, my internet browser, plus my internet feed is feeding me back my stream on my television, and I've got a second laptop that I have the chat window open in. So I don't think it's the computer processing power. I think it's probably bandwidth. I mean, I have cable modem, but it did say that I have a 6.2% frame drop, so maybe it just killed itself, but it's back up now.
Okay.
But yeah, go ahead.
I was just going to say, we'll stop being adult now that it's back on.
Yeah. And Maz, are you on the table yet or no?
Yeah, I'm on the table.
Okay, so go to note. And there should be, you should be able to see available pre-generated character. And there's a list of 27 to choose from in there.
you were a ranger last night, Chuck?
Yeah, I was running a monk ranger. Well, a monk that was just using a bow for the most part, rather.
So there's at least one of every class in there except the Defier. And the Defier, by the way, is a class I made. And I have just noticed I neglected to make a character for that. I should do that. You guys can use Defier if you like. It's a class that I made up, but it's in your library. You should be able to see it.
Can I get a brief description of Blood Hunter, Witch Hunter, and Defiler?
Yeah, everybody says it's Defiler. A Defiler is a person that has bad sex. This is a Defier instead of a Defiler. But a Defier, I know everybody does that. Same thing with, I don't know what the people's thing with elves is. People keep calling this game Savage Encounter, and it's Salvage Encounter, but I don't know. Maybe I got to stop using words that have elves in them. So a Blood Hunter and a Witch Hunter are both classes developed by Matthew Mercer from Critical Role. Do you know who that guy is?
Yeah, I know. I just haven't read into the classes.
And actually, ashamedly, neither have I. And so you probably will know. I mean, you can open the class in the library and read about it, and you're going to know more than I do when you read it. A brief description of both of them is that they have like rituals and stuff. I have a really bad memory, you guys. Just know that about me personally. I have a bad memory. So like the Defier class that I wrote, I can't really tell you much about it because I did it a year ago and no one's ever played one. So I can't really give you a brief description. I'm sorry, but you can read it. You have time to go in and look and see if it's anything.
I happened to buy that off of DM's Guild, and I will check it out maybe the next game.
Cool. The thing with the Defier that I wrote is it's more of a mysterious character that nobody knows what they're about. And, you know, because part of the mystery of that class is that no one's ever seen one before. So it's got all kind of special, depending on which station you take. There's three different stations, and the station's the same as an archetype. And so it's got, like, Tortured Mind one of them can spell cast, the other two can't, but they can do other special things, so they're kind of weird. But I tried to make it so they're not overpowered or that they don't break other classes.
Yeah, you just went offline again on my phone.
Oh, yeah, I see the stream is locked up again. Don't know what that's about. That is a shame.
You have a Patreon page. We can upgrade your hardware, maybe.
Right? If everybody gives me $1 million a month. Yeah, this I'm running this off of my laptop that I got last year is a i7, you know, NVIDIA GeoForce 850M. I mean, it's pretty, I don't know why, and I have a download speed of like 90 and an upload speed of 6, so upload speed isn't that good, but it's good, should be good enough.
Yeah, we were noticing Twitch slows down on Sundays and Mondays for some reason. Maybe people are bored, they get off work on Monday and or everybody's watching Twitch.
Because it
might not be you.
I mean, I do show that I have some drop frames. That is true, but let me... There's a Twitch, or there's a site that you can go and look at, like, the map of the United States, and it shows you Twitch outages or slowdowns.
I think it's the water on your cables in that northwest that are...
Yeah, Twitch outage map. Here we go. Yeah, mine's I'm yellow, but you don't want to be in Europe right now. Apparently, they're having a problem.
Yeah, there's a lot of DDoS attacks going on these days. I work for an ISP, and we're dealing with customers that are getting hammered.
Wow. Yeah, it appears to be back, the stream to, and this time mine never crashed. It just locked up and then went back to normal. But luckily, I've learned to record locally on my hard drive as well, which also could be using CPU. But that way, if the stream screws up, I have a copy of it that I can upload it to. All right. It doesn't look like we have any other players that have come in that are wanting to play, so maybe we can get going. Maz, have you decided which one you want?
Yeah, I'll go ahead and try the Defiler.
I haven't made one.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, you haven't.
It's made not one on the list, and it's Defier once again. No L.
Yeah, yeah. I keep saying that. I don't know why.
That's because you like to defile people. I know about your personality.
Well, I mean, this is
true.
A guy that focuses on persuasion. I mean, of course, he's going to defile something.
I should just rename it and be done with it. So which one do you want?
Let me look at it real quick, because I thought you had one, but you don't.
No, I don't.
All right, looks like we're going to use a half-elf variant warlock.
Half-elf variant, which one? Warlock.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so he's in there if you want to open the characters and grab him. And he's all ready to play except for his picture.
All right, so I still go to character selection, open a new one, and then drag him over or somehow?
No, if you go to character selection, he should be in there as a black box, and it should say pre-gen half-elf variant warlock, and then you should just be able to click on him and bring him up. If you had, there you go. And then you can just name him and pick a picture, and it'll be fun. Oh, wait, no, I think you made a new one, didn't you?
That's what I think.
Yeah.
I did.
Yeah, you did. You made a new one. Let me erase that. So in that box, there should be you should see pre-gen. If you don't see it, close it and open it again. And you should see pre-gen level 1 half-elf variant warlock.
Yeah, but there's no mark to drag on the things in the box.
No, you just click on it. You just double click it. Is it? You don't see it?
Yeah, I double clicked it. Nothing's popping up.
Okay, so close the PC window. Just close it. make sure it's closed. Then click on the characters thing again, open that back up. And the pre-gen level 1 half-elf variant warlock, you should just be able to click it, and it should go right to the top of the screen and give it to you and open the characters.
All right, so I'm going to notes. I'm opening up pre-gen.
Not notes. Not notes. Characters.
Okay. Oh, okay, I see it.
There you go.
Perfect.
Okay. Now you can rename it and give it a... And, Michael, you still need to rename your character. It's still called pre-gen level 1 Dragonborn Fighter.
All right, man. I'm going to give it a name right now.
Okay.
There we go.
Oh, so you're not going to be Thorn. You're going to be Rogar. Okay. Got to go change that.
Oh, sorry. I forgot about
that. That's okay. That doesn't matter. You can do whatever you want. It's just in order to keep the world only has 5 people in it now, but it's eventually going to have hundreds and hundreds of people. So I'm making lists and keeping spreadsheets and doing all this kind of crap to keep track of stuff so that, because I know if I don't, it's just going to get way out of hand. So I had already typed in Thorin, because that's what you said, but I'm going to go change it to Rogar.
Okay, cool.
Welcome, Percival. Does this game provide inspiration to begin?
It will, and I will give you that. We got another player who I'm going to give permissions to right now since I find him. There he is.
I'm not seeing Salvage on my powers.
Okay, let me... Look at that. Which character?
Urash.
And you're looking for Savage?
Savage, what was it again?
Savage Attack?
Yeah, Savage Attack.
Okay, so on your action stat, go ahead and on the weapons bar, on the gray weapons bar where the magnifying glass is, click on it.
Got it.
And do you see where it says crit 20, melee range 20, melee extra crit dice 1 in melee?
Yep.
Whatever you read on the forums that talked about a power that or an effect that goes in your character sheet, that is not right. That's how you do that. When you roll a crit, it will give you 1 extra dice.
Ah, excellent. So I don't even have to worry.
Don't even have to worry about it. And if for some reason it doesn't work, you let me know when it happens. Oh, because it's going to happen. You're going to crit sometime.
Yes, I will. And it looks like Tyndall joined us.
Yeah, he's going to be in here. Lindel. What's up, Richard?
Hey. How's it going?
Good. Do you want to grab a... We're just getting ready to... I mean, we still have 15 minutes of character building left, but if you start now, you probably won't be done in time. Do you want to grab a pre-gen?
Sure.
Okay. If you go to the notes and open up available pre-generated characters, you can pick from that list of 27. Tell me which one you want, and I'll bring them in.
Do you have, in your two clerics, are one of them a life cleric? Or your three?
Let me look, because there are two of the same build. Let me look. Ooh, how am I going to do that without... Okay, hold on. I'll just bring them all in and look and cancel the ones that we don't need. First of all, are you having trouble choosing a portrait, or you just haven't done it yet?
Just haven't done it yet. I'll do it right now.
Yes, the one, if you open the character window, Richard, the one that's in there now is a life.
Awesome. Then that is the person I will be.
Okie dokie. And what are you going to name your guy? Richard.
Give me just a sec. It won't take long.
Okay, no problem. Jack, I love it.
Yeah, I figured it was simple.
Okay, I have put a vote in the chat. There's absolutely no hurry. If you guys need a couple more minutes, that's perfectly fine. But when you are ready to go, click that so that I know. I'm super excited about this world, you guys. This should be, it's quite the experiment in social, you know, building a D&D world that hundreds of people are going to be in. And you can come and, you know, people can come and play every session, or they can play once and then play 2 years later or whatever, you know. I don't know what the hell, but we'll see how it goes. Should be pretty cool.
Did you create this yourself, or...
Yeah, I just thought of the idea, and I have a general scheme in my head for how it's going to go, but the encounter that you guys are going to do today, or the thing that's going to happen for you guys today, I pretty much just made it up today, and you guys will see as we go along, you will actually participate in helping to create the world. And you'll see what I mean when we start.
Putting that junk together.
Populating the junkyard. So Twitch itself, the website, is featuring my channel on Wednesday at 5 p.m. Pacific for 2 hours. I did not ask them to do that. They just emailed me and said, hey, we're doing an RPG spotlight. We're going to put you up. They looked at my schedule and said, we picked Wednesday from 5 to 7. I actually am not DMing then, unfortunately, but I do play in a game, Storm King's Thunder, and so apparently my channel is going to be flooded with people that day. So that'll be cool, yeah. And then at least people, even though I won't be DMing, I'll be a player in the game because it's Chris's game. It's a FSH Schmoes game. And at least I'll be, you know, get a lot of people to my channel and hopefully get some more followers and stuff like that. So it should be pretty cool.
Sweet. I hope he knows.
Yeah, I did. I told him.
So
he contacted his players and he said, it's very important that you guys all be on time Wednesday. Wink, wink. Right, Rob? And I'm like, yeah, that's funny. Sorry, what were you going to say?
Your new ad campaign should go over well with all the new viewers.
Yeah, I'm hoping so.
This is a great idea, by the way. It's just I haven't seen it, but I'm glad you created this this idea.
Yeah, I wanted to have something that, you know, because people want to play, but you know, you have families, you have jobs, you have, you know, people have adulting, right? And they can't be, you know, it's really hard for a lot of people to be like, okay, every single Wednesday at 5 p.m. I'm going to do this, and I can't, you know, I got to block it out. People can't just do that. So this way you can show up as often or as little as you want, and you know, I'll take the first six players, and my Patreons get first, I only have two Patreons right now, and neither one of them are here tonight, so. But yeah, they would get first priority seating, and then if it's time to start the game and there's 10 people that want to play, we'll do like a random drawing and bring people in, you know? And sometimes people want to play for an hour and they got to leave and they bring the next guy in, so I think it's a cool idea. All right, seems that everybody's checked the box. Awesome. So welcome to the game, you guys. I appreciate you showing up. Grab a group of five. This should be perfect. So why don't we go ahead and just have you guys, I know a few of you, if not all but one of you, don't even know much about your characters because you just picked them. But starting on the top left with Jade, why don't we just have you guys introduce yourselves to each other, tell your, you know, what your character, a little bit about it, two or three sentences, whatever you want to do, and we'll start with Jade.
Her Jade is a ranger,
and she is probably your definition of crazy cat lady.
Okay, Jack.
Hi, Jack. Is your cleric? He's a life cleric, so he'll be focusing a lot on healing as much as possible. He likes to focus on buffing the party more than direct attacks, but if he has to, he can lay down some divine damage.
Awesome. Percival, yeah?
Yeah, I'm Percival, a warlock. I seem to be a lot more distance-oriented, definitely a squishy caster type. I'm pretty calm in most situations. I'm a good guy, you know, I like to steal from the wealthy and give to the needy, and yeah, should be pretty fun.
Awesome. Rogar?
I'm playing Rogar. He's a Dragonborn fighter, and he places family and clan above everything, and abides by the laws.
Okay, cool. Urash.
Urash. Urash. He's a half-orc barbarian.
How do you say it?
Urash.
Urash, okay. Bust my balls if I don't get that right, because I will
no miss worries.
It 55 times.
We started off right. He is a half-orc barbarian that has a great axe that he calls Bergman. And this axe he found in an iceberg. That's why he calls it Bergman. And he believes that it was forged in the blacksmiths of Odin. So he wants to use it, and he charges in quickly, but he will listen to his party if they're persuasive.
Okay, great. Thanks, you guys. If you don't have the combat tracker open, first of all, is there anyone here on the table that is not familiar with all of the functions of Fantasy Grounds? Don't be afraid, because I'll be willing to help you.
I'm not familiar with all of them, but I've been playing a couple games.
Okay, so you know about the combat tracker. So open up the combat tracker, and I have an extension installed called Start Effect. Some of you may notice on your Actions tab that you have an effect under a category called Start Effect. And what that does is when I drag it into the combat tracker, it applies the effect for you. So that's pretty cool. An extension allows URL style. Sorry. Is there a reason that got caught? Oh, you did. That's a mistake. Okay.
Yeah, I was just dragging. Yeah, it's dragging the window.
So if you guys see it, in Rogar and Jack have effects applied to them that always apply for their characters. Rogar has resistance to cold, and Jack has resistance to poison, and he has advantage saves for poison. Advantage save for poison is kind of a note, because it's not really an automated effect. But so if you guys have anything on your character that should be in the combat tracker and don't, let me know. But otherwise, I think we're good to go. And if you guys want to open the party sheet, which is the on the upper right, it's the eye with the three little men on it. Who's to say they're men? Maybe they're women. I don't know. But then you can see all the characters in the game. In there. You can see what people's race and if they have dark vision or, you know, if they have whatever their race or their class and all that stuff. All right. So you guys are a group of five adventurers that have met up to do adventuring, and you are in a city right now, and Jade, what is the name of that city that you're in? Did we lose Jade?
How about Farville?
Farville. Okay, you guys you guys are in Farville, and Jack, what's the population of Farville? Is it a small village? Is it a hamlet? Is it a large town? What do you think? Actually, I can give you some... hold on 1 second. I'll give you a little thing to look at regarding that. I thought I would. Maybe not. Stand by.
So medieval town with jousting and Victorian preferences.
Okay, stand by. When I come to you, be ready with those ideas, because I will put that down. Why don't I have my population table on here, damn it? Maybe I called it something else other than city. Okay, so Richard, did you get that table I just sent you?
Ah, yes, I did.
Okay, so pick, you don't have to roll, you can just pick if you want. Thorpe, hamlet, village, small town, large town, let's stop there. Let's not make it any bigger than that, but which one of those would you like it to be?
Let's have it be a large town.
Okay, and you can either roll for the population or, well, I guess it's, no, yeah, I guess you can't because it's going to, if you roll the wrong one, it's going to give you, but you can pick between 2,000 and 5,000, any number between that you want the population to be.
3,335.
Okay,
for
cool.
Shits and giggles.
Okay, and who was it that was saying, which character was saying stuff about the medieval jousting and what? Who was that?
That was Urash.
Okay, Urash, so tell me, what buildings do you see in the town? Just give me three or four places, kind of what you were saying. Go ahead and tell me what you were saying.
A smithy, a tavern, and an inn.
Okay, great. And Percival, who is the leader of this city and what is their position?
That would be Barak Longshanks, and they are the provisional mayor of this district.
That's a fantastic answer. Provisional mayor. All right. Rogar, what is the name of the inn and the name of the tavern?
The name of the inn would be... Oh, man.
I'm using that. Oh, man. O-M-A-N. No, O-H-O-H-M-A-N. O-O-M-A-N. And what about the tavern?
We'll say the Dark Ale or something.
Okay, the Dark Ale. Cool.
Dark Unicorn.
Even better. Okay, so you guys have arrived in Farville, a large town with a population of 3,335 people. You know, by hearing people talk and by just walking through and meeting people, that the leader of this town is the provisional mayor, whose name is Barak Longshanks. And you see a smithy and a tavern and an inn and several other buildings. You're near the tavern and the inn, which happen to be right next to each other, the O-Man Inn and the Dark Unicorn. And you guys go proceed to the inn to have some drinks and some food. Today is the first day of this calendar in our world. So the year is 1501, and it is First Hammer, which is the first day of the week in a 10-day. And if you guys click on the calendar on the upper right, you'll be able to see this calendar that I'm looking at. It's the icon that looks like a paper calendar. And it's currently 10 in the morning, and you guys have met here. And... you guys are sitting in the tavern, and you're having some drinks and listening to people and deciding to become a group of five adventurers. And who walks in but the mayor himself, Barak Longshanks. And he boisterously announces that he is looking for some help. He is in need of some adventurers to send on a quest. And a lot of the commoners and, like, drunkards and stuff that are in this tavern kind of just like put their heads down, like, nah, I'm not doing it. What do you guys do?
Urash stands up and says, "Is Odin smithy? Is the forge on fire?"
Is that like it? Does the Pope shit in the woods? Is that what that is?
Kinda, but I wanted to name the smithy Odin smithy.
Oh, okay, good. Then you just did. Okay. He says. He approaches you and he says, "Yes, of course. Everyone knows that. You look like a hearty group of adventurers." And he proceeds to just launch into his speech about how you guys might be able to help him. He says, "The old dockyards once served as the primary center of commerce in this town. Years ago, political pressure from an influential merchant, who shall go nameless, who wanted the docks to be closer to her business, forced shipping concerns to move their docks upriver. And the new facility accommodates larger ships, and the old docks fell into disuse. Talk of converting property into a set of riverside shops died when a rat infestation proved to be an unsolvable problem. Thus, the old dockyards have been decaying for years." He says, "Please help me to retrieve an item stolen by Maltimer the thief and his warfling pets. We think he's hiding in the riverfront area."
What can you tell me of Maltimer?
"We only know his reputation. We have never seen him. But he is a great thief and has troubled many lands. And he has now stolen an important item from us here in this town. And we would ask that you retrieve it."
"Can you tell me more of the item?"
He says, "You'll know it when you see it. There's a great reward."
I turn to the companions and say, "Why not?"
The reaction of the people in the tavern was very strange. Did you notice? I say that lowly so Barak can't hear it.
Okay.
He is the provisional mayor.
But it seems the people don't wish to have the item back.
Well, I don't know if the people know of the item per se, but have you seen the city? Not exactly a five-star hotel.
I don't want to. Well, okay, never mind. I'm not going to say anything. Go ahead. Keep going. I just didn't want there to be a misunderstanding. Did I say anything? It worries me. Well, no, I can't jump in. If you guys, maybe, yeah, never mind. I'm a bad DM. if there was a miscommunication, I should just let that be part of the game. So go ahead. I forget I said anything for the last 30 seconds.
So are we rightly to perceive this Barak is not feigned by his patronage?
You're asking me?
Yeah, was the reaction of the people when he walked in strange?
No, it was just more of a DM device to get you guys involved rather than, you know, like, the drunkards and the commoners aren't going to jump up and run over there and go, "Yeah, give me a sword, I'll do it." You know, they're not going to do that. So that was just more of a DM device, sorry.
Gotcha.
But I didn't want to get, if I gave you the impression that they were either afraid of him or bothered by him or any of that, that's not what I meant to do.
"We shall root out this thief."
I'm always interested in treasure.
Yeah, I want to turn to Barak and be like, "Do you recommend a place to start? A specific building or specific area?"
"Yes, I do. You would proceed to the riverfront," and he points a direction, and he says, "It's very obvious, the area. You'll know it when you see it. It's dilapidated and run down. And should you go and retrieve these items that were stolen, there shall be a great reward."
All right. I want to specify items or item.
He says you'll know. You'll when you find it, you'll know.
All right. We're on it. You've hired the best in the city.
Okay. You should proceed immediately to the docks.
All right. I look to the companions and I start heading towards the door.
I will follow Percival.
Likewise, likewise.
And likewise.
We want to have a very theatric exit to impress Barak.
There's music in the background. You hear faint music as you guys walk out. Dun-dun-dun-dun, that kind of a thing.
Our coats kind of sway in the breeze as the door opens to make way for us.
Right.
I like it.
Okay, right, so we
go out to the city and start heading in the direction he indicated.
Okay, and you guys are able to go down as you start walking toward the direction he points. It's very obvious. You can already see, like, maybe a quarter mile or so down the way, the dock area, and I will share a map here with you guys so that you can see where you are. In one moment.
While we're waiting, our highest intelligence is 12, so...
That's awesome.
I'm lower than that, so I'll follow someone smart.
Not nice. Not nice.
Well, I mean, we're lacking some mental capabilities in this group, for sure. That don't stop us at all.
So when you guys get the map, you can place your tokens inside the red square wherever you'd like.
Well, mine's already in there.
And you can move it if you don't like where it is.
It's not letting me. It's every time I click, it's dragging.
My bad. Yeah, this is going to be... It's a learning curve, guys. I have you on the wrong layer. That's why. Never mind. Let me fix that.
All right.
Okay, there we go. Now you guys should be able to put yourselves wherever you want. And you'll notice if you try to move your token, I've locked the token, so you'll see the path will draw where you're going, and then I'll approve your move.
All right, got it.
Okay, one second. Okay, so you guys get here, and as you approach this dock, a slow-moving river flanks this wooden walkway along the eastern and southern edges. The walkway's western edge has one intact building among several ruins. Massive holes provide a view of a lower walkway and the water below it. A stench of ancient mold and hints of urine, nice, lingers in the area. An intact wooden barrel stands in the north end. What would you guys like to do?
I'm going to go ahead and kind of just look around. Do I see any living things?
Let's just see.
I'm going to the doorway.
Let me, give me just a second here, and I will, tell you the answer to it if you see anything living. But you can move, you can, what am I trying to say? You can move your thing if you want to go toward the door. And just as you do,
yes,
you do see something. Just as you start to move, even as a matter of fact, even before you move, you notice that there is a swarm of rats to your south coming toward you. And I would ask everyone to please roll initiative. Dun, dun, dun. And I'm assuming you guys all read the house rules or know my house rules. It should be very fun because what I do is you guys all roll initiative, and then at the top of every round, I re-roll everybody's initiative. So I'm hoping that that's super fun.
I like that.
And because of Fantasy Grounds, it takes 0.2 seconds to do that.
Well, I mean, rolling a natural one, of course that sounds amazing.
Yeah, did you really? Shit. Okay, so apparently the swarm of rats has decided that its initiative, it's got like super high dex or whatever, who the hell knows what's going on. But it is first. And it is going to come right at the nearest person. And actually go inside and swarm all over Urosh. And it is going to try to bite. And believe it or not, the swarm swarms all over Urosh and misses. So it is Rogar's turn. Do you want to cancel the move that you put in there?
Yeah, I want to cancel the movement I put in there.
Okay. Huh. So what would you like to do? You've got us. Right next to you, there is a swarm of rats attacking your new companion.
Well, can I do it? Are they just totally covering him, or can I? Wow.
They're totally all over him. Yeah, they're just, I mean, they're mainly they're just around his feet and legs because he's, you know, they just got there and they're kind of trying to climb on him and bite him. But it is a swarm that's pretty much engulfing him.
I guess I'm just going to have to hold my action because I really don't want to.
Well, do you want to, when you say hold your action, do you mean ready in action?
Yeah, just ready in action.
Okay, what action would you like to ready?
I'm gonna ready.
Did we lose him? These little rats are nothing like the beavers that attacked me in my northern climb.
So what action do you want to ready, Rogar?
I want to just ready my breath weapon just in case he can get out of the way.
Okay, so the trigger is going to be you're going to do your breath weapon if he somehow isn't surrounded by swarms anymore.
Yeah, somehow he's not surrounded. Freeze them all at once.
Okay, so I made a note in the combat tracker. Okay, so you've got a ready to action. Jade, what would you like to do?
Well, I'm going to assume that shooting my longbow at rats will be ineffective, so I think I'd like to move up closer and pull out my cat's claws.
Okay, so you can reset your movement so that you can do what you want now.
How do I do that? How do I do that?
Just drag your token to where you want it to be, and I'll approve your move.
Flank these squirrels.
And there is flanking, so yes. I put the arrow to remind you, if you guys can't see it, the swarm is on Urash there. So make sure that you have the swarm targeted rather than Urash himself. And you will get advantage on your attack because you are flanked by Rogar. And if you can't target on the map, you can use the combat tracker to target the swarm.
Worry not about rolling a one. Swing away!
How do I do that in the combat tracker?
Hit in fumble table in here, so exciting times. Richard knows.
Yeah, that always makes things fun.
Okay, and as soon as Jade targets, you may do your attack.
Yeah, I can't. I can't target in the combat tracker and see the swarm to target.
In the combat tracker, if you hold control and click on the swarm, the S, it should work. There you go.
Sure did.
And don't forget to put advantage for your attack. All right. The mighty swarm has been hit with cat's claws. The damage has been done. And you do notice that your damage was not as effective as you think it should be. So that did do damage, but not as much as you think it. You know, it felt odd to you scratching at a swarm of rats. So if you are finished, you can pass your turn. All right. Urash, it is your turn. You are being attacked by rats.
Can I squash with my feet as well as swing my great axe?
You can certainly try, but that would be two attacks. You'd have to pick one.
All right, I'll swing my great axe.
Okay, swing away. You have advantage. Why?
Because my friends are flanking me.
No, you have to be flanking the enemy that you're attacking, which you are most certainly doing the opposite of. So you need to reroll that again, please, without advantage.
I didn't... Oh, okay. Very good.
You have missed, but you did not get a one. if you would like to move or do a bonus action, you may certainly do so. If not, please pass your turn.
It's not letting me move.
Yeah, there might be. It's because of the, the layers and the rats are on. Let me see if I can take care of that.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead and move. Yeah, I'll move the rats out of the way for a second, then if you want to move where you want to move. So you realize that if you're moving there, you're going to take an opportunity attack from these rats, right?
Yes.
Okay, and you have a 40 movement?
Sorry, 30. Let me move that again.
We want to go to there then. Correct?
Yes.
Okay, a couple, maybe one or two rats hang on you, but not they pretty much all stay there. But they are going to get a opportunity attack for you running away. So let's see what happens.
Taking some of them with me.
They all seem to be freaked out by your disengaging, even though you didn't officially disengage, you did run away. So you did not get hit. Excellent. And if that's it, pass your turn. And Jack, you are up.
Okay, so I'm going to use Sacred Flame on the rats.
Okie dokie. Guess what? They succeeded their save.
Little buggers, okay.
They are little buggers. Percival, do you want to move over there?
Yeah, I'm going to move over there first.
Okay. What madness will Percival unleash on these rats?
I'm going to shoot an Eldritch Blast.
Ooh, and you hit. And you do some damage. And your magical damage, you feel, has full effect. So you liked doing damage to the swarm of rats.
All right, as a bonus action, I'm going to say that these rats are magical in nature, I believe.
Okay, and that's not a bonus action. That's just a free action to say something.
Okay, as a free action, I'll let everybody know.
Should you want to take a bonus action, you can certainly do that if you have one. If not, pass your turn.
No, I'm going to move one more time.
Okay.
Hi.
You can do that.
How are you?
Awesome.
Passed.
All right, now I've... Going into round two. You got to be careful. The rest and the initiative buttons are right next to each other. Holy crap, you don't want to hit them. Jade is up. You are still flanking the swarm.
Yeah, the cat's claw didn't seem very effective. So I guess I'm gonna try the short sword this time.
Okay.
Still have advantage, right?
You absolutely do. That is a hit. Okay, you notice that that is also not as a strong of an attack, and I neglected to allow Rogar's use of his breath weapon if he wants to do that, because Urosh did get out of the swarm, and you had readied a breath weapon. You don't have to do it, because it looks like you might breathe on a friend.
But yeah, I can do.
Did you want to do it, or you didn't want to do it?
Do it. We need the magic.
I think
we'll be fine without it.
Oh, boy. I'm having... You cut out there. I didn't get what you said. Oh, did we lose you?
No, I'm here.
Okay, so you want to do what now? Oh, so, Michael, are you listening to us on the stream, or can you hear me in Discord?
I can hear you in Discord.
Oh, okay, because it sounds like you're taking a really long, like I ask you something and it takes you 10 seconds to answer me, so I just want to make sure you weren't listening to the stream instead of Discord. So, yeah, go ahead and tell me what you'd like to do. Did you want to breathe on the swarm?
No, I don't want to breathe on the swarm because I end up hitting one of my other
okay.
people.
Okay, fantastic. So, Jade, did you want to do anything else on your turn?
No, I think I'm done then.
Okay. So, Rogar, it is your turn now. And you do have melee advantage if you want to make an attack.
I'm going to...
Okay, you did not target the swarm, but I will tell you that your attack did hit, so make sure that you have it targeted and then do your damage.
Yeah, I'll hit. I'll target.
All right, so you did damage, but you did not target the...
Do you not hold down control?
Yeah, you hold control, and you left-click on either the token on the map or the monster in the combat tracker, neither one of which I think you did because it didn't target it. But I can drag that damage onto the swarm and take care of it, so... Just remember for next time.
All right. Okay.
So you notice that your battle axe damage did not do full damage to the swarm. So it's resisting your slashing attacks, but you did do some damage. And if you'd like to do anything else, go ahead. If not, pass your turn. Urush, do you want to do that movement?
Yes, I rush back in with my friends flanking him with advantage or no?
No, because you don't have somebody across from you. So they have advantage, but you do not because you don't have anybody here in that space. Flanking is directly across from somebody. Yes, if you went there, you certainly would. Look how smart you are.
Thank you.
Because I didn't even see that until you did it. Awesome, yeah, so you can totally roll an advantage right there.
Thanks, okay, I will do that. The Great Axe does some damage based on the Hrogar, so I will do the same.
Okay. You roll with advantage and you hit. Your axe comes down and slices on something. And you put it into critical condition. This... Swarm, who somehow went first and now somehow goes last. I don't know what's going on.
Percival, take them out.
Anything else from Urush? No, okay. Percival, you are in fact up.
Let's hope for the best.
All right. You have Eldritch Blasted the swarm and you've hit it. Your magical energy makes all kinds of crazy noise and kills this swarm. Nice job, guys.
Nailed it.
Nailed it.
Nailed it.
And now, what do all players crave?
Loot and XP.
Exactly. So let me give you... XP. And no, those rats didn't have any. Are you supposed to be moving?
Yeah, I mean, is there anything else in sight? I mean, was that the only thing we've seen?
No, I have to give you XP first, then I'll get back to what's going on.
All right, perfect.
All right, so you all got a whopping 10 XP for that encounter. That swarm was worth 50, and you guys killed it. Nice job. First level. Okay, so you are technically out of combat at this point, so yeah, you can move about and... Continue to go investigate this area. And I will tell you about this building. So Yurosh has bravely gone inside, so let's find out what's going on. Judging from its appearance, this building served as a warehouse. The remnants of shelves lined the walls, and a broken desk covered with crude illustrations sits in the middle of the building. Seemingly dragged from its original position, a pile of other debris serves as a makeshift barricade near the entrance. A campfire smolders near the southern wall, and the smell of cooked animal wafting from it.
Looks like somebody's, looks like been, somebody's here been here recently.
Let's see.
Steampunk this junk.
There is a man who appeared to have been sleeping here. He sort of startles and sees that Yurosh has come in. And what would you like to do? He seems friendly. Let me see if I can put a token here for you.
Okay. Hello, friend. We just destroyed some magical rats. How are you?
Stan, I'm setting up something here.
Okay.
Okay, so you tell him that you destroyed some magical rats. Is that what you... So you're lying to him. Okay. He says, well, welcome. I've been sleeping here in this ramshackle place for about 6 months. I witnessed the manifestation of Chitrakik, a rat demon, on my last adventure, and he retired to these parts, and I've been looking for him. What brings you here?
Ah, he must have been the leader of the magical rats we destroyed. What more do you know about Chitrakik?
And he goes and he shuffles through the papers and he pulls out a sketch. And it's like a charcoal sketch. And he says, this is what he looks like. And, you know, it's just a charcoal sketch of like a rat dude. I don't have an actual picture to show you. He goes, this is what he's looked like. And I've been looking for him, but I haven't been able to find him.
Donner, why are you looking for the rat man?
I need to find this guy who has needles for teeth, and because he has eyes everywhere, and it's my charge to find him so that I can perhaps get information or even maybe recruit him for... my group across the river.
What group is that?
I knew you were going to ask me that because I just made that shit up. you tell me, what is the name of the group across the river?
The Cult of the Rat Taters.
Okay, hold on. I got to put this down. This is awesome.
We're still a little fired up from our fight, so we don't hit like rats.
Yeah, well, this guy is just somebody I was told to come and find, and I've been looking for him, obviously here on the docks, but also around the town of Farville, and I have not come across him yet. And then as you guys start filing in, he says, oh, I see you have friends, you know, and he still maintains a friendly demeanor. And he says, if there's anything I can do to help you, great, but I would also appreciate if you could help me to find this Donar. No, I'm sorry. That's the guy's name. This Chitrakikik.
Have you seen anybody else around this area recently?
No, I haven't actually. This seems like a pretty deserted place, which is why I've been pretty safe here. I mean, I only really sleep here. I just got up now because I was sleeping tonight, but it stays pretty quiet, but I'm gone most of the time, so I haven't seen any funny business or anything here.
So if our treasure's around here, it's likely in the hands of the same gentleman. I think we should hunt together.
Oh, he says, well, I would be happy to accompany you. These are dangerous part. And just as he says that, through a little hole in the wall to the south, which on this map you can't see the southern wall of this, the map ends at the bottom of this room, but there's a little hole in the wall, and another rat swarm appears in the hole. Right after Percival takes a step back. So, everyone can roll initiative.
Donner, do you encounter these pretty frequently?
Yes, I do. We should be able to dispatch of this quickly. But they are quite dangerous if they get a hold of you, so do be careful. And
I can attest to that.
Jade, you're up first.
This time I think I will try the bow.
Okay. So you hit with a mighty arrow that you determine does not do as much damage as you think it should.
Shucks.
Anything else for Jade?
No, I think that's all I got.
Okay, you're up. Rushes forward and is next to the swarm of rat.
How do I activate rage? It doesn't have the little button anymore.
Yes, on your character sheet, down on the bottom on your actions tab where it says group, click on that till it says actions. And there's the button.
Got it. There you go.
So Yurosh flies into a rage and is now, like, screaming and yelling. And yeah, go ahead. And he brings down his great axe, but he forgot to target, so let me... misses.
I'll re-roll that.
No, you're not going to re-roll. You missed. You forget the target. I don't give you the benefit of rerolling. Would you like to do anything else after your great shank of the great axe on the wood of the floor?
I'll stay tight, hoping to. Well, we can't really flank him with this position.
Below the thing is rats. You could flank on left and right, but whoever's on the left would be squeezing. So you get all kinds of disadvantage and stuff when you're squeezing. So unless this thing moves.
All right, maybe I should move to force them to move.
If you move, you'll take an opportunity attack.
I'm good with that. Advantage for the attacks is good.
Okay, so you move, and just as you do, these rats try to bite you. And they miss. So you successfully are able to escape to there. If there's nothing else, go ahead and pass your turn. And Rogar, you're up.
Oh, okay then.
And Rogar rushes down to be beside the swarm of rats. And he swings with his battle axe, but forgets to target the monster, so the DM does it for him, and no, you missed. Here's the thing that I need to tell you. Sometimes you target, and you haven't done it when you think you've done it, so you must always look in the combat tracker and find your character in the combat tracker, and when you've targeted somebody, it will actually say target swarm of rats or whatever. That's how you can verify. I know it's frustrating until you get used to it, but sometimes you think you've done it and you haven't. But you can always look in the combat tracker and see whether you've got it targeted or not. So in the future, just do that, and it'll make it much easier for you.
So just for a hint, if you're using the control button that you use for push to talk, it won't select it. So you got to use the other control button.
Oh yeah, if you're using control, I would suggest changing that to a different key for push to talk. Because that will screw you up, yeah.
That's what just happened to me, by the way.
Okay. So Rogar swings his battle axe, but he misses. Anything else for Rogar?
No, I'm good. I'm going to hold my position.
All right, go ahead and pass your turn, and it will be Jack. Okay. Jack has decided to come up and brave the as of yet unacted swarm of rats.
Sorry, I was just moving for future moves.
So Jack is going to come through the door.
I moved to Urosh. Okay, yeah. If I know you guys want to move, do your moves way before your turn. But I will tell you, just as a player and as a DM, a lot of shit can happen before you move. So I'm not going to tell you not to do your moves prior to your turn, but it's best to wait until your turn. Also, it also helps that there's not a bunch of annoying white lines waiting around for six turns to get to you. So like I said, you guys don't have to do that, but it's better to wait. So Jack comes in the door, and?
Can Jack see the swarm from where he is?
Yes. Are you doing Sacred Flame?
Yeah.
Yep, absolutely. And they fail.
Aha, okay.
Yeah, Sacred Flame.
Burn, motherfuckers.
Right? Energy screams from the sky and sizzles a couple of these rats. And it is now Donar's turn. And what does he do? He's got stuff. Donar sort of whispers to you guys as he passes. He says, you know, I have druidic powers. And he comes right over here. And you see him extend his hands at these rats, and they all just kind of crush up into the corner. And they all just like fly and splat against the wall. And then just land back down in their space. pretty much where they are, but they all just kind of, he basically thunderwaved them and did some damage to them. And he's like, take that, rats. And it is their turn. And they are very diplomatically going to decide who to attack.
I think you skipped Percival there.
Did I?
You did.
I don't think so. Percival doesn't go till after the rats.
Not according to the combat tracker.
I have it set in the combat tracker so that all monsters appear at the bottom of the list, and you do not know when their initiative is.
Okay.
Never mind then. So they will always all show up at the bottom of the combat tracker, and you will not know where they appear in the list. But I can assure you that the swarm of rats has an initiative of 7, whereas Percival has 3.
I trust you. I just didn't know.
Keep on me, man. If you guys think something's wrong, I absolutely do not mind. If you try to say something like what just happened, I totally don't have a problem with you guys are like, what the hell, man? You skipped me. Like if I need to tell you, what the reason behind that is, then I'll explain it to you. But it is the rat's turn. And they are going to swarm on top of the druid and do their thing. And they do their thing. And they do some damage to the druid, but not that much. And it is, in fact, Percival's turn.
I'm going to go ahead and do what Percival does best. Eldritch Blast.
Okay, don't do it yet, because you've targeted the druid. So, because the tokens are stacked. So, yeah, go ahead and target the rats, and then I'll put them back. There you go.
There, I think I got it.
So you Eldritch Blast this swarm of rats, but the blast misses the rats somehow. There's a 9 million rats and you missed them. I don't understand. But you did. anything else for Percival?
Nope, that'll be it.
Okay, round 2. Reroll initiative. Not you guys, I'll do it. You guys get to roll on the first round, but... So Yorosh is up. And he moves up to the swarm, which is on top of the druid. And he swings his great axe, but to no avail. Off to the side and no good. But he now knows that the walls are made of metal rather than wood.
I'll stay there, and I think Rogar can get behind to create some advantage.
All right. If there's nothing else, go ahead and pass your turn. And Jack.
All right, I'm going to move in just a little bit more. Ah, shit.
You want to go there? Okay.
Yeah. And then I still have the rats targeted, so I should be fine with that. I'm going to cast Sacred Flame again.
Okay. Sacred Flame it is. Energy comes down and hits these rats and does damage. And these rats burn. And they burn in a beam of energy doing 1 point of damage. Awesome. Okay. So it is now going to be Jade.
I think I'm going to have to run up.
Okay, you run to there.
And I will go with the short sword.
Okay. Yep. So you put the smack down on your sword. You do not hit the rats. You luckily do not hit the druid as well. Somehow you're able to miss it all. And it is the swarm's turn, and the swarm is still engulfing Donar and is going to attack Donar and miss. How can a swarm of rats miss? I don't understand, but it can happen. So, Rogar, it is your turn, and you move over. So you will, in fact, have advantage against your target.
Rogar swings with his axe.
All right, mark advantage and swing away. And it is a hit against the swarm of rats. The battle axe comes down and does some kind of damage. And it does pretty good. Puts that swarm of rats in critical condition. And if there's nothing else, go ahead and pass your turn. And Donar the druid is going to produce flame on the rats and burn those rats to death.
Woohoo!
Very nice. So he says, thank you for your help. Those rats are so annoying. They just appear all the time. And I never know what to do. And he says, but I'd be glad to assist you in your quest if you'll have me until I feel the need that I must go off to other duties. But as of now, I can assist you in your quest.
Well, it seems we're looking for the same person.
Perhaps that is true. Why do you seek this person?
We were given a mission.
Something valuable.
Oh, thievery, huh? I don't know that Chitrakik. I'm gonna put the guy's name in chat so you guys don't think I'm nuts. That's what his name is. That's what I've been trying to say. Chitrakik. And he says, I don't know that Chitrakik is necessarily thievorous. I don't know if thievorous is a word, but it is now. There is an idol that he had. And I know it to be worth 50 gold pieces. If you guys can help me find the person that has that, or him, then I think that's why he came here. He was looking for this idol to bring back to our people. We don't know who stole it, but it was stolen, and we've had intelligence tell us that it's in this area. And so I've been looking for him to try to join up with him to help him find this idol. So if you guys want to help me with that, then perhaps we can work together to our mutual benefit.
Rogar says, this sounds like a honorable mission.
Yes, quite honorable.
What does the idol look like?
The idol is a small stone idol of a rat demon. And I have not seen it myself, but it should be, you know, once we find an idol of a rat demon, there's probably not many of those around, so I'm sure that'll be the right one.
Have you searched around this area already?
I've searched the docks, but only once and a long time ago, because like I said, I'm usually gone trying to... I just made a cursory search of this area, but I didn't find anything, and I spend most of my time trying to find Chitrakik in the city, but no one seems to know who he is or if he's here.
Do we have any feeling that this guy has been lying to us at any point here?
Yeah, that's what I was about to do, a perception.
You can go ahead and roll an insight check in the tower. One of you can do that, whichever one you decide.
How do you do it in the tower?
You grab the left click and hold the insight check on your character sheet on your skills tab and drag it down and drop it in the dice tower on the right hand side of the screen. You guys have the dice tower?
Yeah, it looks like a dragon.
Yeah, so just drop it right in there, and that way I'll be able to see the roll, but you won't see it.
Urash is not too insightful.
Yeah, I'm just plus one there.
Whoever wants to, it should be the person who asked the question if they want to check to see if he's telling the truth. There we go.
There you go.
First of all, you think that he's absolutely telling the truth. And the rest of you, the other four of you, can roll a perception check in the tower as well.
Did that work?
No. Nobody's done it yet.
Sorry, did you say perception check?
Yeah, everybody except Percival should roll a perception check in the tower. So I have Rogar. I have Urash. I have Jade. And I just need Jack. Jack, are you there?
Oh, yeah. Sorry about that. okay. Sorry for being scattered.
You roll a perception and you drop it on the dragon in the right hand.
Oh, corner. He knows how to do it. He just wasn't paying attention.
Yeah, exactly. Sorry about that.
Okay. So, again, Percival, through the insight, definitely thinks that the druid's telling the truth. The rest of you, as you're listening to the conversation, pretty much as a group, think that this is not the person that you're supposed to be looking for. You think this guy's a pretty earnest, pretty upstanding guy. You do not think that this is the thieverist person that you were sent down here to find. So that's kind of the information that you perceive from the situation.
I will communicate that with my group, and then recommend. If
there was a misunderstanding, I meant to say that all the four of you who aren't Percival did decide that's what how you feel.
Oh, okay.
So as a group, I had you guys do all perception checks, and as a group, you guys kind of look at each other and nod your heads, and you're like, "Yeah, this isn't the guy we're looking for. This guy seems like a pretty good guy." And he offers to join your party and help search for the guy you're looking for if you wanted to.
Yeah, that one I'm definitely agreeing on. I liked that idea.
Donar, can we refer to him some other name than Chitrakik?
Yeah, we can call him Chick.
There you go.
Chik. Attention all streamers, this is not a slam on women or the female of the species in any way. It is a name of a character. Chicks?
Yeah, there's a T in there.
That's the demon rat, right?
We'll call him... No. Chick is Chick is the guy who he's trying to find. The Donar is trying to find this guy named Chick, and he's trying to find him and or the idol of the demon rat.
Oh, I got confused. Okay, my bad. I was like, because if that's the demon, I'm probably just going to call him Fuckface.
No, this is just a dude.
So, might Chick be the thief?
No. Remember, Percival asked him... isn't that what Percival asked him?
No, Percival.
If this Donald guy was in any way suspicious...
Oh, right. No, you think he's an upstanding guy. You think that he's, a good guy. And he's looking for his friend or his... Well, I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to call him a friend. But he's looking for a member of his, people from the what are they called? The cult rat. Of the rat eaters. Yeah, across the river.
That's it.
So, but you neither think that who he's looking for... you neither think that he himself or the guy he's looking for is the guy you're looking for. Follow me?
Got it. Gotcha. Same guy.
Right. Okay, so what do you guys want to do?
Before we head out, I want to see if, like, is this strange that this one building is metal and all the other buildings are stone and worn away?
Are you asking me? I mean, I'm
asking the group. I'm like, is this normal? Is there something up with this building?
Maybe Donar can tell us. Donar, is this some kind of barrier?
I have no idea. This is just a place I found on this, it was abandoned, and I came here to basically have shelter while I searched the city for Chick, and it seemed more fortifiable and more solid and more weather-resistant and so forth than any other place around here, and nobody bothered me when I set up a little campfire in here, so I just chose it. But other than that, I have no idea that it's special or that it, that it's anything other than just a building here on the wharf area.
All right, good to know. Where were you planning on looking next?
Well, I've been searching all in the whole city and everything, and I haven't, that's all I can do is really, they told me to come over here and look, so I'm doing it, and after what I think is a good amount of time and I haven't found them, I'm going back. So, I don't know. And you guys all got 10 more points for that other, 10 more experience for the other swarm of rats that you killed. So he says, I'm pretty much at your disposal. I mean, I'll come with you guys to help you find this other guy because I've searched all around the city, for many days and I haven't come up with anything. So I might as well lend a hand to you and see if there's something I can't do.
Take us somewhere you haven't been, Mr. Donner.
I've been everywhere. Like I said, I'm just here to follow you guys. If you guys don't want me to follow you around, I can take off because I can go do stuff. But there's really nowhere I can lead you. I mean, I've just been in the city. I have nowhere specific to go. I have no direction of any place good to look. I'm just kind of wandering around. And, there's nothing else I can do to point you in any certain direction. If you guys would like to have me along, great. If not, I'll just take off.
Guys, do you think we should look around this area a bit more?
Yes.
Yeah,
so
I gave
along the water.
Right. I gave this entire area when he says that he means the map. I gave this a cursory look the first few minutes I was here and didn't find anything. That was several days ago. I haven't looked since.
All right. I want to announce to the group that I might be able to help a little bit. We should probably search this area again pretty good since this guy gave a cursory look. But I have background in urban bounty hunter, so I might know someone who's got some info as far as tracking people.
So what do you guys want to do?
I want to go ahead and inspect this building, at least look under all this boxes and wooden stuff, because I kind of feel like this is a suspicious building to have a giant metal building in the middle of rubble, essentially.
Okay, let's see. So whoever rolled survival, Yurash, yeah. So
looking for tracks.
Okay, part of the way I DM, and you're forgiven for this. You don't have to. I'm not yelling at you or anything. Since you did it, I'm just going to explain. Any roll that you make as a skill check or an ability check or even an attack or anything that isn't something I call for will simply be you having fun rolling dice. So, I like to. Richard knows this because he's played in my games before. But I like to have you tell me what you'd want to do. Like, hey, I want to track a guy, and you can say, hey, can I make a survival roll? But any roll you make on your own that I don't ask for won't be. That's nothing, right? So I have to kind of prompt you for it. And that's just a particular way that I play, that I like to DM, so that players just don't go, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, and just start throwing dice in there. You know what I mean? So just make sure you ask me and tell me what it is you want to do. But if you'd like to, what'd you say you want to do? Track a guy?
Check for like tracks or anything. Just do a general search.
Okay. A general search for tracks would definitely reveal that they're all over. There's mud and dust and footprints all over these docks, like literally hundreds of them. So are you looking for something in particular beyond that?
I guess clues, but yeah, that's not specific enough.
Yeah, so, and I understand what you're getting at. If you want to track somebody in particular, you first have to know who you're tracking. But this whole area is just completely, I mean, there's no way you could follow any one set of footprints in the area that you're in. It's not like you're out in the woods following one man or something like that.
Got you.
Rob, I'd like to take a look around the dock area.
Maybe go down one of those ladders.
Agreed.
Okay.
I'm trying to look in down these holes.
Okay, so just then as Jade goes where she goes, stand by.
I am so falling.
Ah, shit.
You walk on a weakened section of the dock there, and we need a dexterity saving throw from you, and if you'd like, you may do that in the open. We're looking for a 12. Oh, and you make it.
So, well, I'm a cat.
Yeah, right? Just as that area gives way, you're able to leap out of the way and land there. And that whole area where the trap is falls away, but you do not fall through it.
Guys, the boards are loose.
You are able to escape your falling destiny there. I guess it's not your destiny if you didn't do it. So you come up here and stand by 1 second and I'll kind of describe. I'm going to move you, Percival, and I know that you went out the door and around. I know you didn't go through the wall. I'm going to describe what you see here more in detail.
Nice save there, Jade.
Oh no, I it was a nice save. I already told you that the rivers wash. Okay, I already told you guys that. Let's see. Let's see.
Does the map show indication where there's other traps?
Like some? You guys, now that that's happened to Jade, you guys can sense that there may be other weak spots. So you just have to be careful. If you're actively searching for them, you can let me know. But as of right now, you can't tell where it might be specific spots, but there's sure to be more. Oh, what happened to the... Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, so you see that one. So if you want to say, oh, I'm going to look, you know, before I go move, I'm going to look to make sure I don't fall in a trap or whatever, step on a weak spot or whatever, you can do that.
Yeah, that one spot looks a little thin there, so I walked around that. I want to check this barrel out, though.
Okay, so over here to the right... sort of over there. There's the end of the walkway is undamaged compared to the remainder. A ladder at the southern terminus leads down, and a large oaken barrel, not at the top but otherwise whole, rests along the edge. And Doran tells you that's where I came up. I parked my boat on the beach over off to the east a few hundred yards, but then I came up over there, and there's really nothing down there, but it sort of, that's what led me to this building here, is it sort of looks undamaged as opposed to the rest of the place. But anyway, he tells you that. And then just as you guys are, just as Yurosh comes up to look at that barrel, his passive perception notices something in the south.
It's a warfling, I see them.
And he shouts out, it's a warfling, I see them. Hairy, ugly, and usually dripping with water, the warfling is a nocturnal raider and fond of stealing from fishmongers and jewelers alike. And this is what it looks like.
Very cool.
And you may all roll initiative. All right. So up first is Rogar. You can see them. You would have been able to turn upon Yurosh's shouting and definitely see those three things over there. They look like they're ready to attack you guys. What would you like to do?
I yell at the rest of the group, this way, and I charge.
Charge.
Yes.
There we go.
I move there and I exhale my breath weapon at him.
Oh, okay, excellent.
Your breath weapon is a, what is it, a cone? Gotta go find it. You are a... do you know, before I look, I mean, do you already know what your breath weapon is?
Yeah, it's a cold cone.
It's a cone?
Yeah, it's a silver dragon.
Okay. So it is a 15-foot cone. So it seems to me that you should be able to get all of those. I'll say you can get all of those. So go ahead and target all three of those and use your breath. If you want to know the easy way to do it, on the top of the map, there are some targeting things. One is to clear all targets. One is to target all enemies. One is to target all friends. If you guys didn't know about those are up there. But yeah, you've got them all targeted, so you can go ahead and shoot your breath weapon by hitting the attack.
I don't. My breath weapon just disappeared.
Well, that's because you ticked on the circle to indicate that you've used it, which you probably didn't mean to do. So we'll go back to preparation and give that back to you. So what you want to do instead is hit the cast button, and then since it's half on a save anyway, you're going to do damage no matter what. So after you hit the cast button, you would then hit the damage button. And if you're looking, going, where the hell is the cast button and damage button, then just let me know and I'll help you.
Yeah, that's what I was looking for, the cast button.
Okay, so on your character sheet, if you're looking at breath weapon under powers, click on the magnifying glass to the right side of the breath weapon, and it will open more buttons. And do you see cast and damage there?
I got it.
Okay, then just do those right in a row. And he breathes, and guess what? Dead, dying, dying.
No way.
Nice.
The good first shit, little dude. Dragonborn comes to the rescue.
Bad breath.
Bad breath.
And his halitosis-infused breath kills all of those things outright. Nice. Nicely done.
Rogar, thanks for the XP.
Yeah, very right. Nice, very nice.
And that was a quite uneventful. let me give you XP for that. Even though in the old editions, they would have just... only he would have got XP. You guys wouldn't have got anything. That's not how it works.
I was curious. It's like he did take them all out himself without any help. I was wondering if he'd get solo XP.
You guys, no. That doesn't work that way. As a matter of fact, you guys all get 15. So, there's a mound of trash back there. Just to let you know. So now that you've dispatched of the warlings and discovered a mound of trash back there, what would you guys like to do? I know that Yurosh wanted to check that barrel. That barrel appears to just be an old barrel. It doesn't have anything in it, and it appears to be nothing.
All right, something we could ride down the river, but nothing of value.
And, Jade, did you say you wanted to go down a ladder, or you just were looking at the ladder?
Well, given the trap, I think I'd like to look first, but at some point I would like to go down and look at the underdock there.
Okay. If you peered into one of the holes, you would see what you see. There's really not much else to see down there. It's all dilapidated and broken up. And you distinctly get the feeling that if you tried to climb one of these ladders, it might not work out so well. Because this place is
fair enough.
But there is the matter of the pile of trash, if anyone wants to investigate that. Otherwise, what do you guys want?
Yes, I want to...
I have no bonus in investigation.
You said you, yes, I want to, and then you didn't say anything else.
Yeah, I said I want to investigate that trash.
Oh, you do? Okay. So you look through the pile of trash, and you discover some of these Warflings' gatherings that they had stolen from people, and you find in there some inexpensive items, 9 copper pieces, a tin dog whistle, a copper hairpin topped with a silver-plated mermaid, a dented copper halfling tea kettle, polished brass buttons, and a silver fork with the middle tines missing. And you determine that although these items aren't worth that much, you do feel you could probably get some money if you went and sold it. So I will put all of those items in the party sheet for you guys. And when you go back to the as of yet unnamed store, you might be able to sell some of those items. Okay, so it was over before it started, but Donner comes rushing up and says, oh, was that more rats? What happened? Did you breathe? That was kind of, I heard something. That was kind of cool. And you don't respond, so that's fine. So, yeah, what do you guys want to do now?
Get on my level.
Well, like I said, I might know somebody who knows something.
Nah.
Who said they might know somebody that knows somebody?
Percival.
So, who might you know?
My background is in Urban Bounty Hunter. And I have a feature called Ear to the Ground. Right.
So I
might know somebody who can help us track people in a city. You know, because I kind of know the.
Okay.
The players in the underground, I guess.
Right. Totally. And you probably do know somebody that's in the city that could help you tracking someone. However, go ahead and roll a standby. You're going to roll something, but what is it going to be? Roll an insight check in the tower. Okay, so I'm going to say that you definitely think to yourself, hey, I know people, and I've got, you know, underworld contacts and stuff. Maybe I can find somebody who can help us. But you determine that based on the speech that the mayor gave you, that probably everybody in the city that has already made an effort to find this guy couldn't do it. So you're it. Your group is the ones who have been sent to find this guy, and... There may be people that you know that can help you find people generally, but you don't think there's anybody who can specifically help you with this task.
Well, now that we know that it is a... What race was the rat people?
Rats.
So they're just... Okay, so we know that it's these creatures. Can I ask around specifically for them? Because everybody just thought some random person stole this. So now we know that it's rat creatures. So I could ask, you know, possibly and see if anyone knows where rat creatures gather or anything along those lines.
Okay. I thought I may have made a mistake. I thought the mayor told you that. Did he not tell you that?
As far as I was tracking, the mayor told us that Multimer the Thief.
Yes. And he's a rat guy.
Okay.
And did I not say that? Because I should have.
I don't recall that.
Okay,
and,
so my...
And Chick is a rat guy, too.
Chick is a rat guy, too.
Yes.
And his friend
but,
Donna.
Yeah, you know what? That's kind of confusing because... I apologize for that, you guys. They are both rat, but it's not mutually exclusive. Like, for example, you know, I'm a human and Jeffrey Dahmer's a human, but just because we're both, you know what I mean? Like, it's not, it doesn't mean that they're all in the same, just because they're both rat people doesn't mean that they're one, you know, that they're all in the same thing together. So that, I could have chosen that better, but to be honest with you, I kind of had some stuff to do today, and this was kind of last minute. So until right now, until the time we got to this point in the game, I didn't realize it was going to be confusing like that. So don't assume that because one people are rats and the other people are rats that they're in cahoots together. Don't think of it like that. That's my bad. I should have made up something else.
All right.
Are rat people fairly common in this area?
You tell me.
Well, I'm wondering if they stand out when we're looking for them.
If I asked around for rat people, would they have stood out?
No. If you ask people in the town, they are uncommon. It's not a impossibility that you would see them, but they don't generally hang around in the city of Farville. And the fact that these docks have been abandoned and everything, that's why the mayor thought, you know, this is a for sure good place to start looking. Because where else would he be?
Okay, that makes sense.
Is Donner a rat person?
No.
But Chick is.
Yes. Did I not? Let me see if I have a picture of Donner. I thought I did. I don't.
Donner and Chick belong to the same club, though.
I know he's human. A druid. Oh, he's
yeah,
a human.
He's,
okay.
Yeah, he's human. So, yeah, I realized that that was all kind of confusing, but recap. Donner's a human druid who's looking for someone that we'll just refer to, as far as he's concerned, unless you find out different, a colleague of his, who is this Chick guy who's a rat dude. And... you guys are looking for another rat dude who definitely isn't Chick. So if that does that clear it up?
I'm clear.
Yep.
Okay. All right.
I want to ask Donner. So he's part of an organization of cultist rat eaters. Obviously, he knows that at least enough about rats to be searching for rats in this region, searching for his rat, which is not the guy we're going after.
I just realized that. They're called the Rat Eaters. And when you guys named it that, I didn't think about it. And
yeah, I was
so
kind of assuming.
They can't eat rats. I thought it was going to be fun to let the players name stuff, but I guess I have to be careful about that in the future. We're going to have to change that to... they're not the cult of the Rat Eaters anymore. They are the cult of the Bat Eaters. Because I can't very well have the guy be a rat eater whose colleague is a rat. So my bad. Again, this is all an experiment, you guys. I appreciate you guys being patient with me. I'm just trying to learn as I go here. But I thought it would. I read in a how to create your own world thing. You know, rather than just make shit up, let your players help you make the world. So ask them. Who's the what's the mayor's name? What's the guy? You know. So I was doing that, and then I realized you guys name it the rat eater, and it's a rat dude. And you can't. You know. So I can't do that. So. We're going to change that to Bat Eaters. How's that sound?
Okay. I'm still going to pose the same question, Adam. He knows more about these creatures than we do, apparently. I want to ask him, we're not looking per se for your rat, but they could be in the same general vicinity. Which areas would you recommend looking at to locate a rat individual?
As far as I know, the best thing to do is completely search the rest of these docks. There, when I came here a few days ago, I didn't find anything. But obviously, rats started coming at me in the night. And these things that you just blew away over here in the corner, I've never seen those before. I don't know what the hell that was. But I would say that here and on the northern part of the docks, there definitely should be something else to find. And if we don't, then I don't know what to tell you.
All right. I guess we're going to continue our search.
Well, Urash is near the north, so I'll head up to the end of the dock to see what's out on that end.
Okay.
Watch out for traps.
I'll stick to the edges. That usually helps.
I'll accompany him just in case. And can I search for traps along my way?
Yeah, go ahead and roll in the tower for perception. And you're able to make it there without finding anything. And if I move your token and say that you and don't say anything, you obviously didn't fall in.
Okay, cool.
So can I make the leap to the other side there?
Let's find out. If you get a running start, you can jump your strength and feet without even making a roll. So what is your strength?
17.
Yes, you can. You can do it without even rolling. So, for everybody at the table, if you're moving and you want to check for traps, you have to tell me in advance and have me acknowledge that you're going to do that and then make the roll. So, Jack, you're fine on that last one.
Yeah, I apologize.
That's okay. Yeah. I just want you guys to get used to, every time I get a new player, I'm going to have to give that speech, but that's fine. All right, so you guys are coming to the edge. Okay, so Urash runs and jumps. Woo! He runs and jumps across, no problem. And he lands on the other side. Now, I have to find out. So Urash, debris covers the dirt and rocks along the river shore. Two corpses rest among the flotsam, a skeleton and an odd bones and an intact body resembling that of conjoined twins. So that's what you see over there.
Nothing I wouldn't see in the north.
I too am going to attempt to jump up there.
What's your strength?
Can we just... My strength is 13. I have a +3 on my athletics.
Okay, you're going to need to roll an athletics check and, no, sorry, acrobatics check, and you need a, what's your strength?
13.
Okay, so you would make it, you'd be 2 feet short of the edge. So go ahead and make an acrobatics check, and I'll say you need a 12. Or higher, and you may do it in the open if you wish.
I like to live on the dangerous side.
Boom! You barely make it. As a matter of fact, you make it. You have to, like, hang on the side and then pull yourself up.
Shit.
That's awesome. So, you're able to do that. Urash has moved over. I do have something to say. So Urash, when you get over there, this end of the lower walkway holds a nest that is tidier than the others. Stacks of coins, waterlogged books, and other items are sorted into piles. A ladder connects this level to the above walkway. What above walkway? I didn't even know there was one. Anyway. And you have run into somebody. I will share Only you are seeing that, Urash. You've run into this gentleman.
Okay.
And everyone can roll initiative. Okay, it looks like we got everybody but one. Who are we missing? We're missing, who are we missing?
That would be me, but I don't need to, right?
No, everybody rolls initiative. Everybody. When I say everybody, I mean everybody.
Sorry, I will do that now.
And you happened right on this guy. And these are open areas. These nests are open areas, so you guys can all see this. So it happens that it is Jack's turn. From where you are, you do see that. When Urash got right over there, this guy popped out of, like, from behind a crate. So what would you like to do?
Is it clear that this guy means to attack?
Let me show you a picture of who you see as well. 1 second.
Does the picture show intention?
Yes, it does. As a matter of fact, you guys can pretty much all see this guy, even from across the... So I'll share the picture with everybody. You can pretty much tell the intention by looking at what is in his hand.
Okay. This is like drug addict version of Twitch.
And, what does Jack want to do, drug addict?
Jack is gonna move up and swing at this guy with his, hammer.
Okay, you can go right ahead. And that is a miss with the hammer.
All right, then he will end his turn.
Okay, and this guy, Mortimer, hisses and screams at you, "You've come for my things! You shall not have them!" And... he is going to slash his dagger... at Urash.
Obama, you are a thief. I mean, Barack,
and he hits. And 1 second. Okay. He does not get that. So he hits with the dagger. He does 6 points to Urash. And actually, you were raging, weren't you, Urash?
From earlier, I don't know how long
that was. Yeah, I neglected to take that off. So you would have taken the full six there. And then he, after he does that, he runs to there, and you are not able to attack him with an attack of opportunity.
Neither of them are?
No, neither of them are. He has an action that allows him to run away. He has cunning action, basically.
Sweet.
So just then... This rat kind of comes scrambling out of a pile of stuff and runs right up to Jack and stops and does nothing. And just then another rat comes running out as well. And it is Jade's turn. Jade, you have noticed the action across the river. Would you like to move up to where you have your movement?
Yes, I would like to move up.
Yes, I would like to move up.
Okay, and if your plan is to dash and get across the river, I'll count that as a running start.
I actually think I'm going to pull out my crossbow
and
shoot across the river.
But you don't have to do that. What would you like to do?
I'm going to pull out my crossbow and shoot across the river.
Aha! Okay, yeah, you can do that.
Are these two lower rats actually rats or rat people?
The R's are actually rats. Okay, Jade Shu has loosed her arrow and hit rat number three. And killed it.
Woohoo! Woohoo!
Nice shooting.
Right? So that rat is dead. Anything else for Jade?
Nope, I think that's it.
Okay, Jade, roll a perception check in the tower. Okie dokie. Just when you shot that other rat, you think you're able to see that one. And Percival, it is your turn.
All right, I'm going to move up a little bit.
Okay. You can do that.
And then I'm going to target Martimir.
Okay, what are you targeting him with? Doesn't matter. Go ahead.
Eldritch Blast.
Yep, that's fine. And you hit him. You Eldritched him. And he takes that damage. And he looks at you. Whatever.
I want to yell out to the group, we need to catch this rat. Make sure you don't kill him on accident.
Okay.
And that's the end of my turn.
Okay. This rat comes out. Comes right there next to Jack. Doesn't do anything. And it's Urosh. Please draw your movement as you would do it rather than over the water, unless that is what you intend to do. And let me know when you're done and I'll draw it.
That's the first move. I can't go past that, can I?
Yeah, so yeah, you can grab the end of, yeah, there you go, just like that. Okay. All right, I need an acrobatics check from you.
Ah!
Oh, my Okay, so Urash splashes 10 feet below into the water, no damage, but you are swimming.
Can you swim?
Can you swim?
What armor does Urash have on?
Barbarian.
No armor.
No
shoo!
Armor.
Shoo!
Yeah, everybody can swim. He just doesn't have swimming. Okay, so you moved 25, right?
I did, yeah, and I want to throw my axe at him as I fall.
Oh my god. Okay, first of all, everyone should on your character sheet, I forgot to do that. Everyone on your character sheet, go ahead and mark your inspiration circle on the upper part of your character sheet. Go ahead and click that so you all have it. I am going to allow you to throw your hand axe at advantage and keep your inspiration.
Woohoo! Okay.
For that fantastic idea that you just came up with. Okay, let's see if that hit. It did. And you didn't target him again, so let's give him the damage. All right, he takes 7 from a hand axe as you splash into the water. You take no damage, but you are where your token is, but you're 10 feet below that in the water. And so you very adeptly were able to, and threw the axe at him, using your inspiration and then getting it back because of your fantastic idea.
Can I get to that ladder next round?
Yeah, you landed in the water right by the ladder, so you'll be able to go around and climb up and do whatever you have to do.
I will move my turn.
Okay, and Rogar, you are up. Would you like to move that movement 25 feet?
I got a question. If I go to 30 feet, can I still jump?
Yeah, because you can double your movement. So if your movement's 30, you can actually go 60. If you want to run and jump, you can.
I want to run and jump.
What's your strength? 17. Okay, so you can run and jump. Isn't yours 17, Rogar? Yeah, 17. Okay, so Rogar can run there. 30, 40, 50. You can land there with no problem and still have 10 movement. When you land there, I will tell you something that you notice. You see those two rats right there when you land, but you still have 10 feet of movement if you want it, but you cannot take an action.
Okay, well, I guess I'll just head for the rats and brace for impact.
Okay, yeah, you can do that.
AKA prepare an action.
No, he can't do that. He can't prepare an action because he used his... Yeah, exactly. All right, so let's... This guy shows up out of the woodwork, and he does have enough to come over to the newly arrived Rogar and bite and miss. And now the druid, who I neglected to move and would certainly have been up here with you guys. He would have been in the same area that you guys were. I just forgot to move him because I forgot that I had an NPC to deal with. He is going to definitely, whatever he does, not try to make the jump to the other side. He's going to come up to the edge.
Druid them from there.
And he's going to druid from here. So he is just going to do the best he can. And he's going to produce flame.
Come on, Donner.
Come on, you Donner. You can do it. You can do it.
If I can find it on his... There it is.
Ragnar's a dragonborn, so he can resist the fire, so blast him!
Well, you, even though you can resist it, you still take damage. Okay, so he's going to...
I don't resist fire, I resist cold.
There you go. So he does 2 damage with his firebolt to rat number 8, and it is now rat number 8's turn, and rat number 8, 10, is going to come right there. And rat number 8 has biting advantage on Rogar. And something... Oh, yeah, because I didn't mark it, that's what... So he bites and misses, and he, even with advantage. And it is now Jade's turn.
Wow, Jade, 23 initiative. Excellent roll.
Yeah, well, yeah, Rob rolled it.
Fantasy Grounds rolled it. Jade is going to... Oh!
Crit of the night,
everybody!
Woohoo!
Except kind of wasted on a rat.
Except that... why? Your intelligence and wisdom. Oh, okay, yes. On my table, on my fun little tables, there are 5 negative effects on the critical table and 5 positive effects on the fumble table. So you just critted, you still get to do your damage, but you take a negative effect of intelligence and wisdom being -2 for the rest of the encounter. I don't know that that'll have much effect.
Ouch.
Go ahead and roll your damage.
Bada bing.
And you killed it.
Bye-bye, Red.
Bye-bye, Red.
And I need to even find out something here. Let's see. Let's find Jade. Let me just test something here. I'm going to put an effect of an int -2 on you and see if that even work. So you have... Let's see. +1 effects -1. Yes, that did work. Okay, so that's cool. That's how you can do that then. So your effects are intelligence and wisdom -2 for the rest of the encounter.
Can I ask an out of game question? I'm just curious. What mechanism is that? Like,
what
as
do you
far
mean?
As
so, what do you like, mean? What
she rolled a crit and became stupider.
Right, so you didn't hear my... Okay, so my explanation is I have a critical fumble table that I'm using. There's 100 entries on each one. When you roll a critical or a fumble, a 20 or a 1, it triggers a d6 roll. If that d6 comes up a 1 or 2, nothing happens. It's just a regular crit or a fumble. If it rolls a 3, 4, 5, or 6, it goes to a table and it rolls a d100 and it picks an entry. Whatever entry that is the effect that happens. This is all in the rules that I guess maybe you didn't read them, but... And then on the critical table, out of there are 95 positive things, but there are 5 negative things, just to make it fun. I'm just weird and want to throw shit, you know, make shit go crazy. And on the fumble table, there are 95 positive ones and 5 negative ones. So she rolled a crit and still gets to do double damage and everything, but she happened to get one of the 5 rolls that's a negative action.
Nice.
And so that's why if you read it, it says your intelligence and whatever are -2. Yes, this is bad. That's why it says that, because just to be clear that it's meant to be that way. So right, that's
yeah,
what's going on.
Cool. Yeah, I was just curious as to what effect that was. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. Thank you.
And that's and they're all crap I made up. So after if you guys fumble and crit 200 different ways, then you'll know what they all are. Okay, so Jade has become dumb for a second, but also a great killer of rats, and she put one down. Anything else for her turn?
I just want to say, even dumb, I'm smarter than some other people in the party.
Because right? Some people have bad rolls. Okay, this thing.
So I want to move to there.
Wait, no. Oh, hold on. Wait, we got to wait till your turn before you can move.
22 initiative? Someone's got higher?
Yeah, but I can't find it. Does anybody see the doppel rat on the map?
Not yet.
They must have not. Well, since they didn't, I'm gonna put him way down there then, because he didn't populate on the map, so that must have been a mistake. But it's his turn. So, he goes 15 to there. Dives into the water and goes 15 to there. And he's got his eye on Urosh for the moment, who's about ready to climb up the ladder anyway. However, it is Urosh's turn. So the ladder's 10 feet, difficult terrain. So to go around from where you are now to go around to the ladder would be 10, and then it would be 30 to get to the top of the ladder. To right there. So that's 30 if that's what you want to do, unless you want to go a different way.
Okay, so that's my whole movement if I go to there. I did rage.
Okay, that's fine.
And I will attack. I was going to hope to move to the space so I could give Ragnar advantage, but that's too far, obviously. There's no dashing for me, right?
You can dash. You can, any character can dash. You can move 60 feet if you don't want to take an action. But if you go by this, well, actually, no. You can go, if you want to do that instead of attacking, you can go to there. But you would have to go, you would, again, have to roll to get past this open space. So is that what you want to do? You can't go through the rat.
No, I'd rather attack the rat then, if that's the case.
Okay, yeah.
So
that's
let me
fine.
Target him this time without using the push-to-talk control button.
Okay.
I'd like to remind that we're trying to incapacitate this rat.
So if you could do a non-lethal attack, I'm not trying to tell you how to game, but if you do a non-lethal attack with like the broad side of your blade or something, it could knock him out instead of killing him.
10-4, that's what I'll do.
Okay. And just for, I'm glad that got brought up, just for everyone's edification, if you're trying to do non-lethal damage to a creature at any time, but you crit and it goes to zero or below, that is death.
Okay, I'll
so
roll
just,
a
I'm
19.
Telling you guys that, so when it happens, you say that I don't, you know, that I didn't warn you.
Okay, I'll take that chance. 1 in 20.
Okay. Oh, but instead...
yay! That's the point. You don't want to kill him.
Yeah, so you fumbled, but it didn't get an effect on the table because it rolled a 1 on the d6, so that's just a miss. So being very scared, your party reminding you that you have to not kill him, you were very scared and you just decided to miss him at all altogether. Anything else? No. Okay, so... Donner is going to do his thing with it. Fire. And he hits a rat and he kills that rat, which is good for Rogar because guess who's not on the other side of Rogar anymore? An advantageous rat.
Nice.
And it is nice. Jack's turn.
Okay, cool. So I don't have to worry about targeting that thing. Would it be possible for me to try and shove this rat into the water?
Everything's possible, Richard. You can do a... you can do a strength check. if you'd like to do that, and I will roll its counter, whatever the hell it is, and see what we get. You pick this, you shove this rat right into the water without a problem.
Fantastic. And as a bonus action, I'm going to use Healing Word on Ara.
Thank you, Saya.
Okay, yep, you can do that. And Yurash gets healed for 5 points. And it is now Percival's turn.
All right, so the rules for jumping over this, just to be clear, is that I have to have basically just enough movement to do it. And then additionally, I can add strength to it?
No, you have to get a 10-foot running start, which if you backed up 5, you could have a 10-foot running start. And then without making any rolls or anything at all, you can go your strength in feet. So you can go 10 feet. So here's what would happen. You would back up to here. Then you would run and jump. 5, 10, and you would basically get to here without having to do any rolls or anything. Now you have 5 feet to go, so what I would do is I'd make you roll an acrobatics check, and you'd have to get a 15 to catch the edge. And anything higher than 15, you'd be fine. Lower, you're in the water.
All right, got it. I'm not going to do that.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and... I'm going to shoot an Eldritch Blast, surprisingly enough.
Okay. Never a bad idea.
And I'm going to attempt to do it non-lethally to incapacitate.
Okay. Oh, you're doing that at...
Mattimer.
Okay, correct. So you do not have a clear shot, so you need to mark a -2 on the modifiers on the below for that shot, unless you move to where you can get a clear shot, which you can totally do.
All right, I'm going to move there first.
Then you do not have to mark -2. You can just do it.
Okay.
And you hit. And he goes unconscious.
All right, and then I'm going to move back.
So is he prone?
Okay. He will be prone, yeah.
All right, I'm going to move back.
Okie dokie.
And that's my turn.
And one last rat comes out. And scurries over to there and does not. And NPCs don't have this mechanic in the game, but to make it fun and interesting, because you guys obviously don't want him to die, I'm going to make him do death saves. And he fails his first death save.
Medic!
And Rat 25 is in the water. With no apparent way, he's going to have to swim under 10, 20. And basically, actually, you know what? I think, you know, a rat can't climb a ladder. So he's just going to kind of fluster around out there and kind of be out of it, really. He's not going to really be able to do much. Unless somebody comes, well, that's what he'll do. He'll kind of flutter around if somebody gets in the water. He'll be ready.
Gets eaten by a fish.
Could happen. Okay, this rat is simply going to try to bite Rogar. This is rat 5. And he does, but he doesn't. You know what I'm saying? He does, but he doesn't. Rat number 2 has advantage on Rogar. This will be the, we're at the end of the game time today, so I don't like to end games in the middle of encounter, so we'll finish this out, but, you know, we'll go all the way to the end. Okay, so he's going to do his little bite. And does he get a bite? No, he does not. And guess whose turn it is now? Rogar in the middle of the rats.
Well, axe at...
All right, you've hit with your battle axe. Rat number 19. And he, of course. These guys pretty much take... Where is rat 19? Ah, there he is. There he was. What's up? Okay, anything else for Rogar?
I will hold my position defiantly in the middle of them with a mighty roar.
All right, you can do that. Pass your turn. And Rat 23 is going to take his turn. He reaches out with his little teeny tiny teeth, and he actually bites you, and he does a whopping 1 damage.
Rogar!
And Rat 5 starts the new round. And he misses Rogar. Rat 23, same thing, bites and gets a critical hit. Well, a critical bite. And ladies and gentlemen, if you didn't know this about 5th edition, creatures that do 1 point of damage, when they crit, they do 1 point of damage. First of all.
That's hilarious.
Do I notice anything special about this one rat swimming up in the top?
Double rat.
Yes, you do. Even though you currently can't see it, you did see it.
Does he look like he can climb a ladder?
And he looks like he might be able to climb a ladder, this particular rat. He looks like a little bit of a special rat.
Alrighty then. I'm gonna do Eldritch Blast.
Okay. That is a hit. The rat has been eldritched again.
And that's the end of my turn.
Okay. Did you want to do damage, or you didn't?
Did it not show up? It rolled a dice across my screen.
It says you attacked and hit, but it did not do damage.
All right, I'll roll it again.
There we go. That's a dead rat. Cool.
Very nice.
Does it not roll if the dice goes too far up the chat window?
Yes, you must. I don't know about too far up, but it has to be in the chat window. You can't do it on the table or outside the chat window. I never roll dice in the chat. I always click the thing because I don't like that exact thing. That sometimes it doesn't work. So, but that's probably what happened is you saw it roll, but none of us did, and it didn't go in the chat.
Okay, so I can just click the button that does damage. And
yeah, you can drag just it click or... it instead. Right.
All right, perfect.
So this guy... is going to try and take out this rat in the water. And it must just be his little head poking out because he missed. And it's Jack's turn.
Okay. Nobody seems to be taking too much damage. So Jack is going to go on the offensive.
Okay.
Ah, okay, yes, he has plenty of range. He's going to cast a Guiding Bolt on Jerkface over there.
When you say Jerkface, who do you mean specifically?
Doppelrat.
You cannot see Doppelrat. Doppelrat is in the water 10 feet below. You cannot see him.
Oh, okay.
So matter of fact, what I should have done was that. You know he's there, and Yurosh saw him, but you, from where you stand, you can't see him.
Okay. Then can I revert my 10 feet of movement that I did there and then just run straight to the rat?
Sure.
Thank you. So I'm going to go over there and attack rat 2.
Okay. That is a hit on rat 2 with your warhammer. And I'm imagining that no matter what the damage is going to kill him. Yes. So you did.
And I'll end my turn.
Okay, so Doppelrat, as it happens, comes up the ladder. Let's see, 5, 10, 20. He's got climb, so it's not difficult terrain. So it's 10, 15, up 10. Okay, but that's all he can do without dashing. So he's going to come right over here and not do anything. Rat 25 is going to flounder around. Death save number 2. For who's his name? Ooh, that's a failure. He's got 2. And it is Yurosh's turn, standing next to a guy who's most certainly going to die soon.
I'll step over Martimer and sandwich the Doppelrat.
Okay. Please draw the way you're going to go. Okay. Yep, you can do that, and you will have advantage on who's a what's? Doppelrat?
Doppelrat, yeah, I'll target him.
Okay.
Sorry for the multi.
Okay, so we take the one that's right, which is the one on the top, and that's a miss. Okay, who's next? Jade.
So I'm gonna step up next to the druid.
Okay.
So my shot isn't obstructed.
Yep, you've got a nice clean shot to whoever you like, basically. I'm assuming you're gonna do Doppelrat. With your negative 2 in wisdom and... Oh, that's funny. Oh my god, it's a hit with a longbow. And you do full damage on the Doppelrat. Nicely done. Rogar, you will have advantage on the Doppelrat if that is who you are attacking.
Do we need to heal Martimer?
Yes, Rogar swings his...
The answer to the healing question is if you don't, he will most certainly die if he rolls another death save. Fail.
Oh, I completely fucking forgot. Sorry about that one, guys.
Go ahead, Rogar. The Silver Dragonborn has hit with his battle axe.
I didn't roll advantage, but I hit anyway, so.
You can roll it again, because there is a chance you might crit. So go ahead and roll that attack again, and you'll do damage either way. And in fact, you did crit, so go ahead and roll that. Nicely done.
What do you want me to do? Double damage?
It'll do it automatically. Just roll the damage and it'll calculate it for you. That's what we all paid money for. Oh, he's dead. Nice. Good damage on that. Let's see. He's done. He's done. Okay, so, anything else on your turn? No.
Nope, I will hold my position.
Oh, here it comes. He got a 21 on his initiative for being a dead guy. Ooh, and he does not die. It is Jack's turn.
Okay, so I'm going to move up here.
Alrighty.
And use advantage, or use my inspiration to gain advantage.
Okay.
And attempt to attack him with my Warhammer.
You may do. And you do. You hit.
And then, as a bonus action, I will I'll cast Healing Word on the dying Rat Lord Martimer over here, or Madam.
Okay. You heal him for 8 points.
And I will use the rest of my movement to approach him.
Okay. And it is Jade's turn.
Well, let's see if we can get this rat in the water.
Okay. Oh, I assume you do. With a crit. Boom! You see the biggest splash in the water. And a dead rat.
Good job.
And anything else for Jade? Nope. Okay. Donar, knowing that the party did not want to kill the only person left, will stand by, and that makes it Rogar's turn.
Is the rat unconscious, just out of curiosity? Like, he's healed, but
no,
unconscious?
No, he is not unconscious. He is lying prone, and he is fully unconscious and awake and has 8 hit points.
Jim and I grappling.
Ah, okay, good. You're probably going to be able to do that automatically. So I will say he is now grappled.
I'm going to yell across the way to go ahead and tie him up, if you guys can.
He's going to be grappled. Grappled and prone. Okay. So, Percival.
I'm just going to hold my ground. Dodge action.
Okay. Okay, yeah, you can take that. Don't think you'll... Urosh.
All right, I'm going to use Intimidation.
Okay, by this time, you guys would have all... probably, since he woke up from dying, and even though he has hit points, he's grappled, and you guys are surrounding him, it's probably pretty much over. So yeah, you can use Intimidation to talk to him. The three of you that are on the opposite side of the dock, by various use of someone helping you and ropes and whatnot, you'll be able to get across there in a matter of 2 or 3 rounds. So you guys can pretty much have a conversation with this guy and you want to intimidate him, he basically kind of, you know, gives you this, you found me and you found my stuff. Why would you bother me here? Oh, wait, you know what? Well, even if he doesn't, he speaks common now. This little rat guy, he speaks common. So he says that, and you probably don't even need to intimidate him, except for that if you want to intimidate him, what did you want to say to him?
Rogar tells somebody while I'm grappling him, disarm this man.
Yeah, he'll release grip on his weapon and let it go to the ground. And he says, if you just let me go, you can have it all. I don't care. You can just have it all.
Tell us what you know, Martimer.
Okay, so do intimidation check in the tower this time. Oh, my God. That's what you got.
He's not jumping. He's not jumping. Don't let him jump.
He says, what did you ask him? Tell us what you know.
Yeah, tell us what you know, thief.
I'm taking revenge. I'm taking my revenge against this town. All I know is I don't like anybody that's here, and I don't want to kill anybody. I want to steal all their stuff. Take it. They wronged my people. And then he just starts mumbling like incoherently. He's like, I don't care. Just don't kill me. Just let me go. You can have it all.
Rob, I'd like to search for my arrows, but also look in his hoard and see if I see anything special. The mayor guy said we'd know it when we saw it.
Okay, how many arrows did you shoot?
Looks like five.
Okay, roll a d10. Okay, you get back only one of those arrows. Sorry, two, not one, two. It's a D5, and it's half, or whatever you roll, whichever's higher. Wow, that's my bad. Yeah, so you shot five, so you get three back. Sorry, my bad. Yeah, I should do it the way I said I should do it instead of trying to do it in my head. Okay, so and in looking for his stash, it is not immediately, you don't see it. That's why he's telling you, he's screaming, you can have it, but you don't immediately see his stash lying anywhere about.
We're only looking for... Sorry,
At this point, he struggles, and he tries to get away. He tries to break your grapple. He's trying to run. He's like, just take it all, just let me go. And he's trying to run and trying to, like, dive in the water.
I force him on his stomach, and we search him.
Okay, and on him, you find his weapon... and nothing else.
How about my hand axe I laid into him on my fall?
Yeah, that's on the floor. It kind of fell out of it.
Oh, I want to go ahead and say I think we should tie this guy up so that there's no chance of him escaping.
Yeah, we need to search the rest of this dock too, because that stash over there might not have what we're looking for.
Anybody have a tentacle?
You're able to, if you have rope, somebody out of the five of you, somebody has to have rope. You probably all do. You're able to tie him up, no problem. And he just kind of looks dejected, and he's like, whatever, just don't kill me. And now he's like giving up. He's like, it's over there.
Where does he indicate?
He points over here. You don't see it, but that's where he points. And you guys have already been standing there, so you know it's not going to fall through the water or anything like that.
I'll stand guard over him while you guys search.
I'd like to have a real thorough search.
Yes, if you go over there and search, you actually do find a cache of C-A-C-H-E cache of stuff. You find some money, a pair of sapphire studded earrings that look very, very valuable, a silver dagger, a gold ring with an emerald inset that looks even more valuable than earrings, and a variety of keys and mundane items beyond that. Also, that's it.
Emerald earrings.
Yes, emerald earrings, gold ring, and a silver dagger. And I will put all of that, including the money, into the party sheet.
The one ring to rule them all?
How dare you bring that in here?
Do I think any of those items were so special that the mayor guy was looking for?
You wouldn't know that, but you definitely think that those earrings and that ring and that dagger look very special. They like you feel as though these items might be placed under one of those glass things that they put food under, you know, with a gold handle on it. When you see these things, you think, oh man, look at this stuff. You don't think it's just any ordinary treasure. You think it's pretty fantastic.
Do we sense any magic from it, or can I try to sense magic from it?
Do you have detect magic?
I do not. Arcana, maybe.
You wouldn't be able to tell really, but at this point you don't detect magic, no. They just look fantastic. So you guys are able to. He's tied up. He's given up. He's like, whatever. Fuck you guys, man. You know, he doesn't care. He just doesn't want to die. So you guys are pretty much. Think you found what you needed. You found the dude that's responsible. So what do you want to do? Do you want to let him go? Do you want to kill him? What do you want to do?
I want to ask him where he got these items from, first of all.
Oh, he says, I don't even remember. Whatever, I've stolen so much stuff, you don't even know. I've stolen and fenced more than I can remember even to list off. I have no idea where I got this.
I'd like to know why he feels the town has wronged him.
Let's ask Donner if he knows anything. He's a rat lover.
You didn't notice, but in all of the commotion, Donner slipped away.
Oh, I did notice before he did. Oh!
I was, as you were saying that, I was going to find him in the combat tracker to remove him, which I already intended to do a while ago. But he in the commotion slipped away. When you guys were crossing, he crossed with you, and then you got over there, and you were talking to this guy and looking at the treasure and stuff, and he slipped away. He didn't say anything. You don't know why he slipped away, but he did.
I'll be back next time to find out why.
So, if you guys, we want to wrap it up here because we're a half hour over my slot that I want to try to end at 8 o'clock. But like I say, I don't like to just end games in the middle of stuff. So I need you guys to decide if you want to, you know, what are you going? You found what you're looking for, I think. What do you want to do with this guy in particular? He wants you to let him go.
Should we take him back to the provisional mayor and then present the items to see if that's what he was looking for?
That sounds like what I would suggest, yeah.
Rogar would like to bring him back to face whatever criminal charges he needs to face.
Okay, yep, I agree. Fantastic. Yep, I agree.
So you guys go ahead and, you know, tie him up and drag him back to the place where the mayor was, and you guys are probably only down here for, you know, like an hour. So the mayor's still in the bar. And
on the way, can we ask him if he knows anything about Chitrick as well?
Yes, you can ask him that, and he doesn't have any clue what you're talking about. No idea. And he says, the reason I don't know that is because the DM has to write that, so he'll probably tell you next time after he makes it up. That's what he says to you.
That'll make it better.
So you get back with this guy, and you turn him in, and you say, what do you do? You say, what do you say? The mayor's like, oh, what do we have, adventurers? What did you do? What did you find?
We captured your thief and found some curious items on him.
What curious items did you find? And he kind of rubs his hand together like he's pretty excited.
Some fantastic earrings, a beautiful ring, and a stunning silver dagger.
Oh, you have found it. You have found them. So let me find out who I'm going to ask this question to. That is Yurash. Yurash, what is a name of a high priestess?
Philistina.
Okay, so the mayor says you have done well, and the high priestess Philistina will be pleased that you have returned her jewelry. As a reward, we offer 125 gold pieces, and the silver dagger is yours to keep.
Can I do an insight check to see if this guy is bullshitting us, literally just sent us on a quest to see what we could find for him?
Greedy hands there, yeah.
Yeah, go ahead, Richard, in the tower.
Okay.
And can I assist since I was talking to him?
I will give you another roll, Rich. Okay, the first roll was a 1. Second one was an 18 plus 5. Yes, you definitely think he's telling the truth. This was an earnest mission that he sent you on.
Okay.
And
I'm keep
so
my
he, if you guys check the party sheet, I'm going to take out the earring and the gold ring. The silver dagger is still in there, and you guys are going to get an additional 125 gold piece. So the bartender at the inn will relieve you of your sundry items if you wish, and you will be able to cash out your treasure, and I will award XP and monies to everybody. And the only thing that we need to do is decide which of the characters would like to have a silver dagger. How we'll do that, I just, we'll do it like the Adventures League does it. You, people who don't want it can just say, I don't care. And the ones that want it can, who can use it, a person that can use a dagger or benefit from it. If more than one person wants it, we'll just roll for it.
Yeah, I don't think I can use it.
So if you would like to have the silver dagger, roll a d20 in the chat.
Could be magical.
I feel like a rogue could possibly use this as well. Or a ranger.
Or a caster.
I have spells. I don't need magical damage.
Okay, so Jack is the only one that's interested?
Yeah, I think I'm good.
Okay, so I need to put it back in there for you, Richard. Hold on.
If I'm the only one who's interested, then I'm just going to sell it for its monetary value.
Let's find out what it is first.
25 gold pieces would be what the party would receive for selling it. So, and it is not a magical or special dagger, other than it does have the silver property.
Okay.
So you want to just sell it, Richard?
Yeah.
Okay, in that case, everybody is about to get treasure. So everyone just received 45 gold pieces, 1 copper, and 38 silver, which is on your character sheets already. And you will be receiving more XP for your adventure.
Awesome. Does that conclude it? So we're back in the inn?
Yeah, you guys are back in the inn, and you have all received 106. So basically, all the characters, today you got 141 XPs, which means you're about halfway to level 2.
Excellent.
Very and cool. You have completed the adventure Trouble at the Docks that I pretty much just kind of threw together. And now I will tell you the next time, for any of you that want to come back for the next session, you can. And your characters will have things happen. So, like, say, for example, you guys don't play for 2 months or you don't want to play in for a real long time. You don't have to come back every time. Different stuff will happen to your characters. I haven't really figured out what that's going to be yet, but you'll have, you know, you'll get stuff for, you know, stuff will happen in the background is basically what I'm saying. I have to figure out what that is. If you guys have ideas, I'll gladly listen. The next time I'm going to be playing this particular game is going to be Saturday, the 17th.
At what time? At what time?
At 11 a.m. Pacific. So if you guys ever want to know when it is, you can go to my Twitch page and look at the schedule, or the schedule in the Discord. If you're in Discord, just click on the schedule text. It's always in there. So Mondays is all the time, and it's Tuesdays and Saturdays when I don't have the Tuesdays and Saturdays game going. So that's kind of it's sort of hit and miss. But I know the Saturday game doesn't come back until
So this will be labeled Salvage Encounters?
Yeah, Salvage Encounter, ongoing work, which you five helped to initially create starting today. And thank you guys for joining in the experiment.
Kick ass. Thank you for having us.
Yeah, awesome. It was awesome.
Yeah,
thank
it was
you.
Awesome. Thank you.
Okay,
yeah.
I will hope to see you guys again. And again, you guys can come play as often as you want, as little as you want, never again, every time, whatever you want. It's all up to you.
So right. we wouldn't want to use these same characters in other adventures that were different, right?
No, I mean, you can make if you like the character itself, you can copy it, and I mean, you can open up in your character selection, character management in Fantasy Grounds. You will see the name of the Salvage Encounters or whatever it's called, and you could pull that character out and go use it somewhere else, but it would be a copy of it.
Gotcha.
But yeah, you don't, the character you have in my world can't have anything altered, unless it's in the game. So good job, guys. You won. You won Dungeons & Dragons. That's awesome. I love it when players win.
All right, Rob. Thanks, Rob. Have a good night. Yeah, have a good night.
Does anybody have any questions or anything before we go?
Nope, that was a good time. Thanks, Rob.
Okay, I'm going to turn my voice off, but if you guys do have questions, just go ahead and chat me in Discord, and I'll see if I can answer you, but I've got to get something to eat, so I'm going to step away for a couple minutes. But thanks, guys. That was fun, and I hope to see you back.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thanks for
the
game.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, guys. That was a great time.
That was a great time.
I'll see you all again.
Saturday.
It sounds like.
Talk to you soon.
Talk to you soon.